through them streets, bring out the word and prophesy for you. Show them they sins, tell them repent, I do it. All of them around, I'm scared to do it. I'm not, as long as your head's on me,
I got this.
Sisters, hide naked, hide your body. My brothers keep killing each other and nobody else. I ain't got no problem speaking truth right now. But I do better under you. I can't lose when I'm with you. How can I snooze and miss the moment? This is just a warning. I wanna be ready when you do come through to set us free. How can I snooze and miss the moment? This is too important. Nobody can love us like you do, you do. Over 400 years since we've been misplaced, miseducated, violated, I'm sick of this place. Obadiah 118, watch her get erased. Watching niggas love this country, such a disgrace. Prophecy is kicking, I see nations are at war. Matthew 24, not a rumor anymore. Could have been exposed just like hoes with no makeup. Gotta wake up, Jacob. I can't lose.
I can't lose.
When I'm with you,
when I'm with you.
Why would I snooze and miss the moment? This is just a warning. I better be ready when you do come through to set us free. How could I snooze and miss the moment? This is too important. Nobody's in profits like you do.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 3. Neither shall thou make marriages with them. Verse 1. When the Lord thy God shall bring thee into the land whither thou goest to possess it, and had cast out many nations before thee.
First, before you go into that, stay right there. Real quick, give me Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 7. Right? Because we can just tell you, all right, or we can give you the understanding so you understand why these things are written. The Lord created all nations of people. You understand? And he chose a people unto himself. And all the other nations, we're going to show you what the Lord feels about these other people and why it's important for you to love your own people. Right?
Read this. Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32, and verse 7. Now, remember the days of old. Consider the years of many generations.
Verse 9.
Ask thy fathers, and he will show thee. Thy elders, and they will tell thee.
Because what do we learn from? Everything we know today, what we get from?
Here and there upon him, yet he knoweth not.
Society, so-called white people. We, in America right now, we can't go past slavery. Right? And what happened to us in slavery? We were stripped of everything. So all the knowledge of ourselves, all the knowledge of anything comes from the same person who enslaved you. Are your enemy, your oppressor. So the Lord said, in order to learn the truth, you gotta go back to the Bible. That's what the Bible is all about. It's our record. Right? That was written for our learning. You understand? That's why we can come out and open the Bible. That's why we gotta come out in the streets.
The book of Tobit.
Right? We can go open a church, a building, and make some money.
Then
you understand? I can have these brothers in nice suits, man. Right? Have you come, lie to you, have y'all sitting in the seats, tell you gotta pay us 10% of your check every Sunday. You know what I'm saying? Like a damn Netflix. And kind of get paid. You understand? But that only benefits who? Me, you don't benefit the people, because what are they going to go? When they leave the church, they go back to the hood. They go right back to the same around the corner where they selling drugs right around the corner. While these churches bringing in all that money. Nothing goes into our people. Go to the white folks' neighborhood. The sidewalks are nice. You understand? They come and cut the grass. Go to Pine Hills. Go to areas where we live in. Every city, every town, and every nation on this earth has a ghetto and a slum. Who lives there? Us. Right? Why is that even a concept in 2021? So now, 2023.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32, and verse 8.
Bring it out.
The Most High divided to the nations there.
No, you brought all the nations together and gave everybody equal portion.
With the Most High divided to the nations their inheritance.
So the Lord always been about division. The Lord divided to the nations their inheritance.
Right?
Every nation don't got the same. So-called white man can't do the same. He don't got the same thing as you. He can't dance like you. He can't do the things that you can do. He's not as skilled as you. That's why they need us. Exactly. So every name, but he does have something. Okay? And we can show you that in the Bible. His gift was the sword. That's why he makes bombs and go to war and kill innocent people for no reason. Go and steal their land. That's his gift, to be the wicked.
Right.
Go ahead.
When he separated.
When he what?
When he separated.
God did this. When he separated, read.
The sons of Adam.
Adam. Give me 2 Corinthians 16:4. When he separated the sons of Adam. You know who Adam is? Who is Adam? Who is Adam? Who is Adam? Adam was the first man.
Oh yeah, Adam and Eve. Oh yeah,
when Lord created man, he created
Adam. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
I mean, we don't get too deep into that, but he separated the sons of Adam. Read this real quick.
2 Ezra 6:54.
Read it out.
And after these, thou madest Adam, whom thou hast set Lord over all thy, thou hast made it. Of him come
read again,
we,
read again.
Con. And after,
I got it.
Con. And after these, thou madest Adam, whom thou hast set as Lord over all that thou hast made. Of him come we all.
Oh, it is
right.
Yeah.
It's the book of 2 Ezra, verse 54. Bring it out. And after these, Adam also, whom thou madest Lord over all thy creatures.
Uh-huh.
Of him come we all.
So everybody, no matter what race you are, we all come out of Adam. Right? Read.
And the people also.
And the people also.
Whom thou hast chosen.
So the Lord has a chosen people. So everybody come out of Adam, but he made a distinction now. And my people that I chose. Read.
As for the other people.
Now he's going to tell you about the other people outside of his chosen people. Read.
Which also come of Adam.
They come out of Adam too.
Thou hast said,
what God said about
that they are nothing.
They are what?
That they are nothing.
This is what they know that we don't know. They enslaved us, destroyed us, tricked us, gave us Christianity, and told us God loves everybody, and we all equal now after they beat the hell out of us and stole everything from us. But the Bible don't say that. They know this. That's why they hate you. They don't hate you because of your skin color. You're not the only dark person on earth. The East Indian, I can go to the store right now, the East Indian, black as hell.
Yeah, they do.
And they stink.
Huh?
Right? They don't, do they get shot by the police?
Nah-huh.
Do they call themselves black?
Nope.
A color in the crayon box? Nobody's this color.
Nah-huh.
We call ourselves black. I know some darker than me. So is it about skin color, really? No, it's not about skin color. Every nation on the earth has color except one nation, that's the white man. You understand? Arabs, all those people are dark-skinned people. So it's never been about color, it's been about a seed line, a nation of people that all nations have conspired against because of the promise and because of what we're reading to you now. Go ahead.
Thou hast said that they are nothing.
God said I created them, but they're not nothing. Read.
But be like unto spittle.
But be what?
But be like unto spittle.
But be what?
But be like unto spittle.
What is spittle? What is spittle? Spit.
Yeah.
I say they like spit. Do you care about spit?
Nah.
Are you going to get mad if spit drop out of your mouth and hit the ground? Are you going to try to save it and expunge it out of the concrete and put it back in your mouth? No, it's going to evaporate from the sun before you can look at it. So the Lord said they are nothing people. Nothing people do this to somebody.
Right?
You understand?
So of thy people was
and then 600 years later, say, don't get over it, nigga. Don't worry about it. You know what I'm saying? We didn't do it. Our forefathers did. Deal with it. That's just the path. Oh, you niggas still in the ghettos in the slums. Why they steady building prisons? Prison ain't nothing but another slave plantation. It's nothing but free labor. They didn't need to keep us on the slave plantation no more. Because now we already picked $7 trillion worth of cotton. Now they have an economy now. Now we need niggas to work. Now we need niggas to make money so they can spend money and give it back to us.
Right.
We don't need them on the plantation no more. We need these niggas in the ghettos in the slum where we give them bare minimum and a little bit they get, they're going to give it back to us. And they're going to be jealous of one another and fight each other and hate each other while we live good. You understand? Go ahead.
And has likened the abundance of them unto a drop that falleth from a vessel.
From a what?
From a vessel.
The Lord said the best of them, the abundance of them, is like a drop that falleth from a bucket of water. The Lord said they're like a drip drop. They're like rainwater. Read.
And now, O Lord, behold, heathen.
These heathen. Heathen are all nations outside of Israelites. God's chosen people. These heathen,
which have ever been reputed as nothing,
have always been known to be nothing from the beginning. Read.
Have begun to be lords over us.
How the hell are they reigning over us? Now they above us. Now they lords over us now.
You know?
You see what I'm saying? Give me Deuteronomy 28 and 43. Now these heathen, God, you said these people are nothing. Now they reigning over us. Now they locking us up in the prison. Now we gotta go to their school. Now we gotta go to them for a loan. Now we gotta go to them when we thirsty. If I want a job, I gotta go sit down and beg a white man to give me a job. Now I gotta come out here and go walk around and ask people, do they want free healthcare that don't exist? Because you gotta work though. You gotta do what you gotta do. So you got a job. Read? But it's deeper than that. I got a job too, I gotta do. I don't believe in my job. I'm just doing it just to get a check.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 43.
Bring it out!
The stranger that is within thee.
The stranger that is within me is this guy right here, man. You see this Edomite right here? That's the stranger that is within him. Okay? Read.
Shall get up above thee very high.
He's going to get up above us very high. Now, white man is above us now. He's not really better than us. He's not really above us. He's above us now, though. Who's faced on all the money? White man. Who set up all, who made it possible for them to even have an economy? Us! They had to come to the West Coast of Africa and get the same people that built up HD. Read.
God. And those shall come down very low.
And we gonna come down very low. Now we just niggas. Now we just black. We don't have a heritage or nothing. We don't have a land. We don't have an army or military. We just black. A color in a crayon box. I'm black and I'm proud. That's the dumbest statement I ever heard in my life. That used to be a thing though once upon a time. I'm black and I'm proud. And white people used to sit in those dark rooms and laugh. They used to drink wine and laugh. These niggas crazy.
Deuteronomy 30 verse
18.
I call heaven and earth to record
this
day against you.
That's it on that. Now go back to
Deuteronomy.
Finish this up.
This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 32 and verse 8. When the Most High divided to the nations their inheritance.
Uh-huh.
When he separated the sons of Adam.
When he did what?
When he separated the sons of Adam. The
Lord, we're never supposed to be together. The Lord separated the sons of Adam. These sons made up nations of people. Every person on this earth go back to a seed of a man. We go back to Jacob. The white man goes back to Esau. The Arab man goes back to Ishmael. The Chinese man goes back to Moab. The Japanese man goes back to Ammon. You understand? Read.
He set the bounds of the people.
He set the bounds of all these nations of people. Read.
According to the number of the children of Israel.
According to what?
The number of the children of Israel.
According to the children of Israel.
Right?
Read.
For the Lord's portion is his people.
So the Lord created all people. He divided them, gave everybody an inheritance, and he cut himself a portion for himself. He created man, different nations, and he said, this is mine. That's y'all. That's our people.
Right.
Don't seem like that. They don't feel like it. It seems like the white man got shown. That's why he's able to steal y'all. Now he's the Jewish. Now he stole your identity. Go ahead.
Jacob is the lot of his inheritance.
Jacob is the lot of his inheritance. Now, go back to, now go to Deuteronomy 7. I'm still answering your question. Go to Deuteronomy 7 and 3 now.
Con.
Yeah, just jump to 3.
Con. Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 3.
Bring it out.
Neither shalt thou make marriages with them.
We just, the Lord just told you. They nothing. They like spit. Don't make marriages with them. Don't make covenants with them. Don't be friends with the so-called white woman. Don't lay down with the white woman and make her your wife. That's foolish. The Bible literally calls them dogs. Christ called them dogs.
That's right.
We can show you that, film. Yeah, that's why they love dogs. That's why they smell like dogs. That's why they sleep with dogs. Kids, we only do that because we try to be like the white man. That's not natural for us to do. You feel bad about it.
Yeah,
you say I'm
like,
being
am I being racist?
Yeah. Is it wrong to be racist?
Oh, shit, nah.
Huh? No. Is God racist? Yeah. Because race is a bad word. I'm going to show you how they play word games with us. And it's not our language. We're not English.
I heard English is the best.
Yeah, man, it's not our language, right? Oh, we could get into that, although we, you know, we set up. I mean, really and truly, it really is Israelites that set it up. But that's a conversation for another day. So dealing with today, and I understand that modern times understand this, we speak English today. So for example, the suffix ist, I-S-T, what does that mean? Like a dentist. Is it bad to be a dentist? No, nothing wrong with that. What about a pianist? Nothing wrong with that. Right? What about an orthodontist? No. But a racist. A pianist has an interest in the piano. He has a love for the piano. It's a study of the piano. Right? An orthodontist has a love for dentistry. It means the study of dentistry. Racist, every nation is racist except what people, us. We're the only people that's not racist. Racist means you have an interest in your own people. You put your own people first. Everybody does that but us. That's why we always get in the bottom of the stick.
Bring it out.
Because we want to love everybody and hate one another.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? In order for us to love somebody else, we have to learn to love each other. Right? So a racist means you have a study of your own people. We don't even know who we are. We should be racist, though we try not to be a racist in front of the white man. But he don't give a damn about being racist. That's why you have ghettos and slums. Right? That's why you got certain, that's why you got HBCUs. You understand what I'm saying? Why you got damn tax brackets? Right? That's why we the last hired, first fired. These statistics exist. All I gotta do is go research and look it up.
Right?
He's racist. This is his kingdom. He should. He's not wrong for making sure white people are okay. There's no concept of policemen, white people being brutalized by the police. It's only one people that goes through that. You never seen a Chinese march for justice and peace.
Nope.
They ain't got to do all that. The Arabs don't got to march downtown.
Bring it out.
Right? They don't have to go through that. So every nation is racist. When a Chinese man come to America, he automatically, he got to start from the dirt. He got to start from the bottom, started from the bottom, now we're here. That's not a thing for them. What about the Ethiopian man or the African man? No. They come get a business loan. They don't got to build up their credit. They get a business loan and they go right and open up Chinatown. And they come to our community because everybody leeches and sucks the life out of us. Liquor stores. The Arabs open up liquor stores, gas stations, selling damn cigarillos and loose cigarettes all over the place. Yeah, and get a 5-year tax break. And we get denied. Loan denied. They'll pick a couple of us just to show you, nigga, you can do it, nigga. And then Jake gets the money and tell you, nigga, you gotta get on the ground. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got it. Like, no, nigga, you just got lucky. The white man just picked you out of the barrel. You know what I'm saying? And won't allow you to help your people, or he'll cut you down. You see what I'm saying? That only happens with us. Why? It's systematic. It's a system that's been set up against you. You see what I'm saying? Go ahead.
Is that right?
No, what was we at? Go back to Deuteronomy 7 and 3. So everybody's racist. So you used to feel racist, right? But you really didn't, right? You only felt like that because you thought the thought that you had in your mind was wrong because it was white. But really, that was the truth. Your ass stink. Go ahead.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 3.
Read it out.
You shall not make marriages with them. Thy daughter, thou shalt not give unto his son.
Even if you got a daughter, you shouldn't allow your daughter to marry no white man. Go ahead. And not just the white man, China man, no other nation. They got 12 tribes to pick from. The best people on earth, the best women on earth, man. Read.
God. Nor his daughter shalt thou take unto thy son.
So your son can't marry no white woman, and your daughter can't marry no white man. Read.
Verse 4. But they will turn away thy son from following me.
They shall what?
But they will turn away thy son from following me.
You can't believe in what we teaching with no white woman at home. You're going to have to choose. Because she's the enemy. You understand? God said they are nothing. Don't deal with them. They don't believe in God. Read?
Con. That they may follow other gods.
That what?
That they may follow other gods.
Because they believe in other gods. Like white Jesus. That man ain't in the Bible, that's CJ Borges. That's the actual man. That he's an imposter. He's acting as the Messiah. They took our books when we was enslaved and they painted all the images in the Bible and made them white. We can show you in this book, the Bible said they look like you. He didn't have to change the words in the book because we don't read what they say. If you put anything in the book, hide it from a nigga, because why? He don't read it. Right? You just listen to rap music and look at the pictures in the pages. Ain't no pictures in the book. Only way a nigga gonna read the Bible, they put pictures in them. They wanna look at the pictures, right? Go ahead.
So will the anger of the Lord be kindled against you and destroy thee suddenly.
And destroy us. Keep going.
Con. Verse 5. But thou shalt.
The Lord said, don't deal with white women in other nations. I don't want to kill them. I'm going to have to do something to you. Go ahead.
Con. Verse 5. But thus shall ye deal with them. Ye shall destroy their altar.
You shall what?
Ye shall destroy their altar.
But really? What we supposed to be doing? I mean, not now, but during this time, the Lord had law set up. We see these heathen worshiping their God. We had to, according to God, we supposed to go tear it down, man. If they making sacrifices to false gods in our pathway, we supposed to go tear it down, man, and destroy it. Read
God. And break down their images.
And do what?
And break down their images.
And white Jesus pictures that's in Big Mama house and in every church in America should be getting burned. That's a lot. All those crosses should be getting broken down. That's what's gonna happen with Christ. He tearing everything down. Read.
Con. And cut down their groves and burn their graven images.
And all their clubs, all these strip clubs that set up, hey, we gonna tear it down.
Now,
we're in America, the Lord's gonna melt you with fire. Go ahead.
Con. With fire. Verse 6. But thou art an holy.
Here's why. So the Lord told you what not to do. There's a reason. Now he's gonna tell you why, brother. Listen closely. It's very important. If you don't learn nothing else, listen to this, what God said about his people. This is why, read.
Con, Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6.
Because he already told you that they are nothing. They like spit. Read.
Con, but thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God.
Because we are holy, we different.
Right.
Holy means separate or set apart. We are holy to God. That's why he gave everybody a little bit and set aside a portion for himself and chose us to be his children. Because we are holy people, read.
Con, the Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people.
Ordinary people.
To be a special people.
Be like everybody else.
To be a special people.
Why do you think everybody follow us? I think hip hop is the number one white people listening to. Yeah, they're white. Eminem, Mac Miller, Machine Gun Kelly. You see what I'm saying? Everybody follow us. The dress code, whatever we set the standard.
Chapter 1 and verse 3.
Yeah, sag, we sag, they sag. You know what I'm saying?
Rivers of water.
Yeah, we special people, man. They take Esau, don't got no hair. He don't got no, what's his food?
And
what food do they have?
Prosper.
Nothing.
And whatsoever he doeth shall prosper.
This man didn't even know how to survive the winter. What'd you say?
Hot dog.
No. Ain't even hot dogs. No, that's not. We think hamburger and hot dog is American food. No, it's not. All right? You don't even got that. Go ahead.
The Lord thy God,
that's Issachar, right? Yeah.
Had chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
Unto himself, read.
Above.
Below.
Above.
Equal to.
Above.
Above, read.
All people that are upon the face of the earth.
So when the NBA draft come around, who the white man, look, that owner that invested $1 billion into that team, who is he looking to make him $1 trillion? Who is he looking for? Does he go to the damn Waterford Lakes to recruit? Does he go to Lake Nona to recruit? Where he go? He go to the hood.
Because
these are the special people. And he put you in that situation. He threw you niggas in the hood. You understand? Now, God said this. This is why. Because you're a special people, but we don't know our worth. We look at the white man as God. We need him. No, we're only in this position because of what? No, why do we go in slavery?
My
man.
There you go.
We broke the covenant. We broke God's laws, man.
That's right.
Right? That's the only reason why. White man not better than us. Keep going.
Con, verse 7. The Lord did not set his love upon you, nor choose you, because you were more in number than any people. For ye were the fewest of all people.
Yeah, it was only 70 of us. All right, we started off with just 70. Who's the fewest of all nations? But now we that's the sand of the sea, which cannot be numbered nor counted. Now we the greatest people. The white man called us the minority. He's the minority. We're not no minority. It's fewer of them than it is of us. That's why they wanted to separate us. No, it's not. It just seemed like that. Everywhere you go, you see damn white people. Because we, give me Psalms 83. I'm going to show you. It just seemed, when I first moved to Florida, I was like, damn, what the niggas at? You know what I'm saying? I see white people everywhere. I used to go weeks without seeing none of my people. Like, what the hell? Then as I'm here, I'm like, okay, here we go. You got to go somewhere to find them. You know what I'm saying? You got to go to a specific place. We out here. We just ain't got no money. They come out at night. Go ahead.
Verse 8. But because the Lord loved you.
Because what?
But because the Lord loved you.
The Lord actually loves us. The problem is we don't love God. Hold that. Give me Psalms. Give me Proverbs 8 and 4. It's something we got to learn about God. We have to relearn God again because the God that we were given and told about is not real.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? So I can't love somebody I don't know. I can't love a woman I didn't take the time to get to know her. I don't know anything about her. I'm just in lust with her. That's why once that lust passed and you got what you wanted, that shit go to hell now. Because it was never real love. He didn't take the time to get to know the person. So how can you love God if you don't know what he like and what he don't like? You don't know anything about God. You don't know nothing he said. You understand?
Yes.
So you got to do your due diligence. You got to take the time to get to know the Lord. Read that.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 8 and verse 4.
People think God just love you no matter what, just because he made you. Well, I know God love me. No, you don't. Read that.
Unto you, O men.
17.
8:17. This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 8 and verse 17.
Bring it out.
I love them that love me.
I love everybody.
I love them that love me.
What the Lord say?
I love them that love me.
So the Lord don't love everybody. Give me Psalms 5 and 5. He loves them that love him. That makes more sense to me. You understand? I love them that love me. You don't love people that hate you. And we made in the image and likeness of God. That's why we have the same trait. That's why we the way we are. Got it from the Lord. Not the wickedness, but you know, those traits. Somebody's treating you with hate, you ain't gonna sit there and love somebody that you can't trust or try to kill you. Read that.
Book of Psalms, chapter 5, verse 5.
Bring it out.
The foolish shall not stand in his sight. Thou hatest
thou what?
Thou hatest.
Does God hate?
Yeah.
Yeah, he hate. Is that what the world teaches? Is that what Christianity teaches? They say God is love. God don't hate. The devil. It's all the devil. They give all the credit to the devil. The devil is just so powerful. The devil did. Somebody died. The devil did. The devil took my baby. No, God killed that nigga. He was wicked. No, he was such a good. No, he wasn't.
Get out.
He got shot up because he was in a damn game. He got killed because he was in the bed with this nigga's wife. That's adultery. What is your sin is that? Go ahead.
Con. Psalm chapter 5, verse 5.
Bring
the foolish shall not stand in thy sight. Thou hatest all workers of iniquity.
Now what?
Thou hatest all workers of iniquity.
God said he hates anybody who wears sin. Because his son died for you so you can repent. For anybody that's just willfully sinning and not keeping the laws and commandments, God hates that. Because at this point, you're just being disrespectful. I just took you through all of this, and you still, you gonna do the same thing over and over again? Because this time, I'm coming to save a few. I'm bringing salvation, but I'm not saving everybody. Because I gave you time, I sent my prophets and my teachers to warn you, and you had an opportunity to repent and turn from your sin.
And not.
You understand what I'm saying? That's what the Lord is saying. He hates all workers of iniquity. Not saying that everybody don't sin or make mistakes, but you have people who live a life of sin, who don't even acknowledge their sin, purposely doing it. They won't even acknowledge, like Christians. All the, none of the Christians are gonna make it, because they don't even acknowledge their sin. They say the law is done away with. They say all you gotta do is say you believe, and you just say it. You got niggas walking around talking about they saved right now. Big Mama say she saved, but her damn leg, this her right leg this big.
Got that about church, man. They'll just pray for you and be like, oh, you saved now.
Yeah, give me John 9 and 31. You saved now. Nigga, my lights just got cut. What the hell am I saved from? I just found out I got cancer. What am I saved from? The Lord said when you saved, he gonna wipe all tears from your eyes.
Right?
There's gonna be no more debt. No more pain. How am I saved and I gotta pay rent next week? I gotta buy water. When water's
free.
Water's free, nigga. It's literally free. This nigga sell it to you and put it in the bottle. Then it just says, Poland, who the bro, I'm getting angry right now.
Bring it out, man.
Bring it out.
Okay, teach. Teach, huh?
Anybody who don't believe a white man is the devil, I don't know what to tell you. Something's wrong with you. This devil took the Lord's water. It's a felony to catch rainwater. He will lock you up. Here it is, the Lord is raining. The Lord is raining down water for you till you're thirsty as hell. He won't even let you have water. Look, the devil right there, look.
Bring it up.
There he is right there. That's Satan right there, man. With a helmet on, right in the back, right? That's the, literally. The devil means to deceive. The devil is not a man. Can I prove it to you? Because everything we say, we prove it, right?
Bring it out. Bring it out.
Give me Revelation 12 and 10.
Bring it out.
We're not just being mean and we're not a hate group. That's what they say about the Israelites. You see what I'm saying? Read that real quick. I'm going to show you. The devil is not some man with horns that's red with a long tail. That's not in the Bible. Read that.
Revelation chapter 12 and verse 10.
Bring it out!
And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ.
Revelation 2 and 10. 2 and 10. Like I said, 12 and 10. Revelation 2 and 10.
So look at Revelation chapter 2
and 9.
Which one you want?
No, that ain't it.
2 and 9.
Yeah. 10.
Oh, Khan. Fear none of these things which thou shalt suffer.
Because some of us going to suffer that. Some of us that come out and teach all this, because y'all can't learn this nowhere else. You're not going to get this in church. The so-called white man is going to come and afflict us. Throw some of us in prison. Some of us are going to die for teaching this word. But we'll be back. We're going to be resurrected. You know what I'm saying? We the real, when you watch movies like, name some movies.
Any movie?
Superman.
X-Men.
You know the Marvel movies? Where do you think the white man get that from? That's y'all, that's us. Our name, Israelites, Yahshua Allah in the Hebrew, literally means prince that has power with God. Who you think Moses split the sea for? Who you think was healing people and raising the sick and the dead? Us. That's where he got that concept from. We are literally superheroes. We gonna get out. That's why they're afraid of us.
Right?
That's why they shoot a nigga down. They know something is gonna happen.
Bring it out.
When you do people wrong, you waiting on revenge.
That's right.
And they don't know it consciously, but spiritually, something in their spirit just know these niggas gonna raise up. Something got to happen. We ain't just get away with all this. You see what I'm saying? But read it.
Con. Revelation chapter 2, verse 10.
Bring it out!
Fear none of these things which thou shalt suffer.
Uh-huh.
Behold.
That's why we so bold. That's why we'll tell the police to his face, you're the devil, the Bible speaks.
That's right!
And you can't do a damn thing about it unless God allows it.
That's good. Right!
We not like the Crips and the Bloods. Them the weakest niggas in the world. They so damn scared. They only kill people that look like them. That white man pull up, that nigga take off running. You know what I'm saying? He's so gangster. He got tattoos across his damn eye. You know what I'm saying? He rapping about nine bodies. I got nine bodies on me. What that music called?
Drill
music. Come on, he drilling all week. All he's the destruction. Those are the worst niggas.
That's right.
Destruction of their own people. Those are the real coons.
That's right.
Cause that white man pull up with them lights on, man, them niggas gone.
Red and blue.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And that white man can come shoot his mama in the face. He won't do nothing about it. But let a nigga step on his shoes. He crashing out. He willing to do life in prison. See what I'm saying? We not like that. You know what I'm saying? We don't fear them. Cause they weak. We stand up for righteousness.
Bring it out.
You know what I'm saying? I'd rather die for the Lord. I'll die for the Lord.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I'll die for my family.
Bring it out.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Them niggas ain't gonna die for nothing. They willing to die for their money, for their shoes, or their car.
That we should be saved.
Or they set, which is a white man name. A street nigga live on the street with a white man. Hoover Crip. That's a damn Edom. That's a white boy. That's further. Come on, this is my block. No, it's not, nigga. That police come through right now and clear that shit out. It's not your block, bro. It's the white man's block. Go ahead.
Con. Behold, the devil.
The who?
The devil.
The who?
The devil.
Who is this talking about? The devil, right? Read.
Shall cast some of you into prison.
Shall what?
Shall cast some of you into prison.
Who put us into prison? Have you ever seen a red monster with horns and a pitchfork? And a long tail with steam and fire coming out of him, come arrest the nigga and put him in jail?
There you go.
Who is the Bible calling the devil?
Not us.
The white man is the devil. That's who's gonna throw us in the prison.
Right?
Who set up mass incarceration? The Clintons. Bill Clinton, Hillary Clinton, Joe Biden, right? In the 90s, 92. 89, 90, really, before he was president, when he was down governor. Right? So who's the devil right here? The white man. Right. See what I'm saying? It's not talking about some entity that's going to throw us in the prison. We literally fill the prisons. You understand? Now go back. Go back to who was at. I just wanted to prove that and show you we're not just up here making up stuff.
As long as some white people have
you said what?
Is there like certain white people that's Israel or no? Or none of them want to
fight? Now,
I heard some white people come from us.
Oh, they all come from us. We're going to deal with it in a minute. I'm going to help you understand in a minute. Go back to what we said. Yeah, John 9, because we was talking about they just come pray for you. You go to church and they just put their hands and pray for you.
It's the book of John, chapter 9, verse 31. Bring it out!
Nigga say his lights turned off, my kid's lights turned off, and they tell you to put money in the plate and God gonna bless you, and they just pray for you. You just go back home in the dark.
This is the book of John.
No, nigga, if this brother come to me and say he need his lights off, brother, we gonna come up with some bread to get it paid.
Right, that's right.
We ain't gonna say, well, Lord willing, the Lord help you out. What you doing wrong, brother? Brother, you need to repent. No, brother, the brother need help with his lights on. Right? The church should be able to turn on light. The church should be turning on lights. Jesus was out there healing. He was doing things for the people. He's talking about sending your prayer request in. Big Mama sitting on the couch watching it down at 12 a.m. at night. Watching a white man sitting there with the thing going across the bottom of the screen, she calling the number on the prayer line. Sending her money to the dead white man. You know what I'm saying? Crying and everything. Jesus Christ, thank you, Lord. You see what I'm saying? It's bad.
This book of John, chapter 9 and verse 31.
Bring it out.
Now we know that God heareth not sinners.
That what?
That God heareth not sinners.
What is sin?
The truth of the Bible. Disobeying God's word.
Come here, man. That's my dog. There you go. That man on fire, man. Sin is it's simple. Transgressing the laws of God. When you break God's laws, you're in sin. If you sin and you repent, if God said don't eat pork and I eat pork, I acknowledge that I've been eating pork. Now I know it's wrong. I pray and I beg the Lord for mercy and I ask him to have mercy upon me and forgive me for that sin, that he may blot my sin out in the name of his son. You understand? And then I stop eating the pork. That's repent. That's the process. That's the baptism. That's being baptized. That's turning away from your sin. The Lord blots that sin out. If I slip up and commit a sin again, I have a perpetuation in Christ. That's the problem. I repent again. But I don't continue to willfully do it. In Christianity, they tell you that you can eat pork. You don't got to keep the law. So there is no point of repenting. Because repenting, when you repent, you're repenting from your sin. So if I don't got to keep the law, what am I repenting from?
Right.
Nothing. That's why all these niggas that's killing each other, they all grew up in the church. They all Christian. All these niggas that's rap, when they get their award, what they say? They want to thank God. But their number one record that got them that Grammy was talking about drilling on Jay. Was talking about taking his brother's wife. You see what I'm saying? Was doing everything opposite of what the Bible says. Go ahead.
Now we know that God heareth not sinners.
So God don't hear sinners, but what?
But if any man be a worshiper of God, and doeth his will,
and what?
And doeth his will,
and do the will. But if you do the will of God, read
him, he heareth.
So who does God's hear? What is God's will?
Follow after him. God's will.
That's right. May he keep his laws, man. My man on fire, man. See how the Bible's simple. It's saying the same thing from Genesis to Revelation. It's not that deep. Read it.
Con, Psalms chapter 40, verse 8.
So we proven, this is how we know that what you're saying is right. Read that.
I delight to do thy will.
I delight to do the will of God. Christians hate to do the will of God. They get mad when we say you can't eat pork. Grandma trying to throw a nigga out the house. I know the devil is a lot. She throwing shit at you. You know what I'm saying? Because you said you can't eat pork. Her blood pressure going up. She said her blood pressure going up because I done came in there and told her she got to throw the pork out of her. No, your blood pressure going up because you eating pork. Bacon. Yeah. You eating neck bones. You eat a hog, mother. Yeah, you eat them big feet. Big butt. All matter with it. Chitterless, man.
I delight to do thy will, oh my God. Yea, thy law.
Thy what?
Thy law.
Thy laws and commandments, read.
Is within my heart.
Is what?
Is within my heart.
Is within my mind. Your heart is your mind. It's a similar to, it's not talking about your heart. That's why Chris talking to my God, know my heart. You know what I'm saying? No, your heart is your mind. Your heart is an organ that pumps blood. That's all it do. It don't do nothing else. Somebody, I believe in my heart. You see what I'm saying? So it's about repenting and keeping God's law. That's the one thing our people have never done. We've marched. We've done all type of stuff. Right? We've never repented as a nation and kept God's laws and commandments, which is the reason why we're in this condition, why we're in this position. Now let's go back to dealing with white women. Go back to Tobit. Give me Tobit 4.
The book of Tobit, chapter 4 and verse number 12.
Bring it out.
Beware of all whoredom.
So the context is whoredom. The Lord said, beware of all whoredom. Read.
My son, and chiefly take a wife.
And do what?
And chiefly take a wife.
And you ask, can I have a white woman for my wife? The Bible says, chiefly take a wife, read.
Of the seed of thy father.
Of the what?
Of the seed of thy father.
Of the seed of thy father. If you don't do that, what God called it?
6-8.
Boredom. The Lord said, beware that nasty white woman. What's the first thing Jake do when he signed his NBA contract? He go get a white girl. Oh, he get her in college because she know he projected to be a first round pick. Mm-hmm. And her daddy said, go get him. The whole time in high school, her whole life, she said, don't leave them niggas alone. But he know how to keep that money in his family. You see what I'm saying? Go ahead.
And take not a strange woman to wife.
A white woman is a strange woman. She got dog hair. She has no pigmentation. You understand? She walk, but they just different, man. And we're not the same people. And that's self-hate. All right? To choose a woman that don't look like your mother. What's wrong with you? We sick. You understand? Our minds are bad. We've been destroyed. We literally, secretly, unconsciously have a hate for one another. Read.
Which is not of thy father's tribe.
Read.
For we are the children of the prophets.
For what?
For we are the children of the prophets.
We are the children of the prophets. Read.
Noah, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Remember, my son, that our fathers from the beginning, even that they all married wives of their own kindred.
Of they what?
Of their own kindred.
The Bible is very racist. Your pastors, they liars. Of their own kindred.
And were blessed in their children.
Uh-huh.
And their seed shall inherit the land.
And their seed is about nation. It's always been about nation. Right? Now give me Ezra 10 and 10. Now let's see what the Bible says about men who went against that law. Let's see what they did.
This is the book of Ezra, chapter 10 and verse 10.
Because we know our people are rebellious, we don't listen to God. So let's see what happened with the people who married women that's not of their kin.
This is the book of Ezra, chapter 10 and verse 10.
Bring it up.
And Ezra the priest stood up and said unto them, ye have transgressed and have taken strange wives.
It's a sin. You sin against God when you take a white woman and taking strange white. Look, that's strange. That's weird to want that. Strange.
To increase the trespass of Israel.
To do what?
To increase the trespass of Israel.
Harming your own nation. To increase the trespass of us as a nation. Read.
Now therefore make confession unto the Lord God of your father.
We got brothers in that's out here with us right now that have women of white women. And they didn't know what to do. This is what to do right here. Make confession
unto the Lord God
uh-huh.
of your fathers. And do his pleasure.
And do what?
And do his pleasure.
What is God's pleasure?
And separate.
And do what?
And separate.
What do we do?
And separate.
Separate
yourselves from the people of the land and from the strange wives.
And what?
And from the strange wives.
Sorry, baby. I found out I'm an Israelite. You got to go.
That's right.
Show ass up out of here. Straight up like that. That's repentance. That's repentance, man. And that's a hard thing for some brothers to do. We got to choose God. Oh, you gotta choose the world. You understand? These are the things that we are not taught. These are the things that we have to do. You see what I'm saying? Give me Sirach 26 and 21.
This is the book of Sirach. This is the book of Sirach, chapter 26 and verse 21.
Bring it out. 19.
This is the book of Sirach, chapter 26 and verse 19.
Bring it out.
My son, keep the flower of thine age sound,
uh-huh.
and give not thy strength to strangers.
Wait a minute. God said don't give your strength to strangers. What is your strength? What is a man's strength? Is it his arms? Is it his speed? Is it his bank account? Is it his house? Is it his reputation? What is a man's strength? What is the greatest thing that you have in you? Huh?
Nope.
Your seed.
Right.
Your sperm. The ability to procreate. To bring forth a child is the greatest thing. That's your strength. To have a son to continue your legacy and your nation and your name, even when you're no longer here. That is powerful. Your strength. Don't give it. Read it again.
My son, keep the flower of thine age sound, and give not thy strength to strangers.
Don't give your sperm and your seed to that white woman.
Right?
To other nations. You understand? Like them NBA players do. They get their strength to strangers. And that's where the confusion comes. Now you got people who look white, but they really isn't. Like Blake Griffin's son. Blake Griffin mom, you know Blake Griffin, the basketball player? His mom is white, and his daddy is a black ass Haitian. Dark as hell. He's light skinned. Now he married a blonde hair, blue eyed white girl. Now his son look like a straight white boy. Drake. You see what I'm saying? Now it's confused, but they still Israel. That's why you can't necessarily go on looks no more. It's not about skin color. It's about the seed. That's why we always ask people, what's your father? You understand? Because you are what your father is. You're the seed of your father. The man carries the seed. The woman, she's what her father is. She's just the soil. You understand? Go ahead.
Verse 20, when thou hast gotten a proof of possession through all the field.
What's a proof of possession? The field is the world. What's a fruitful possession? A woman. The Lord said, be fruitful and multiply. When I go out throughout the world and I find me and I'm looking for a woman to sow my seed with, read.
When thou hast gotten a fruitful possession.
And I finally find a woman to be fruitful with, read.
Through all the field, sow it with thy own seed.
Do what?
Sow it with thy own seed.
Make sure that fruitful possession is my own people. You got 12 beautiful tribes to choose from. You understand? Go ahead.
Trusting in the goodness of thy stock.
Trusting in the goodness of your stock. Read.
So thy race.
So what?
So thy race.
So thy what?
So thy race.
Race is in the Bible. I thought they said race and color don't matter. Race not in the Bible.
So thy race, which thou leavest, shall be magnified.
Now blemished and diminished.
Shall be magnified.
Yeah, it's not supposed to be no Drakes and Blake Griffin. But here we are. So now we have to be retaught and learn again and get ourselves together. You understand? So that our race may be magnified. Go ahead.
Having the confidence of their good descent.
Having the confidence of who we are and where we come from and who our forefathers are. Because promises come with that. Blessings come with that. Eternal life comes with that. The glory comes with that. A kingdom comes with that, man. A crown on your head comes with that. Rulership comes with that. Slaves come with that, man. Read.
Verse 22, in harlot
that's
shall.
That's it, old man. Nah, you can drop it, man. Did that answer your question?
Yeah.
You got it, boy. Yeah. You understand?
Yeah, I got it.
Oh, praise God. You got any questions?
I am. I know I got questions, but you know, like you said, it's just like, you know, a lot to learn.
Yeah, it's a lot, man.
It's a lot. I got a lot of questions, but it's just.
Give me one question you got. Something you can think about. Like, I was wearing earrings and stuff, man.
To
do
what?
Now you can wear earrings. Give me a.
Oh, you
did?
No, I didn't
show it to him. Give me Solomon 4, I think. I think it's 4 and
But he shall be saved out of it. But the daddy shall fulfill verse 1. And at that time shall Michael stand up as a great prince, which stands for the children of Solomon. And there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was seen there.
I mean, it's a lot we can go to, but he's talking about earrings specifically.
The book of Exodus, chapter 35 and verse 22. And they came, both men and women, as many as were willing hearted, and brought bracelets and earrings.
And what?
And earrings.
And what?
And earrings.
Oh, man, they wore earrings. Go ahead.
And rings and tablets, all jewels of gold. And every man that offered an offering of gold unto the Lord.
You see that? So, you know what I'm saying? It's our heritage. We get that. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing wrong with it. Only thing problem with your jewelry is the image, the item. Yeah, that's what you got to get rid of. Matter of fact, give me her back in 2 and 18. So you may think, it's, you know what I'm saying, it's not a big deal, but you know what I'm saying?
Nah, I get it now.
Yeah.
Book of Habakkuk, chapter 2 and verse 18.
Bring it out.
what profiteth the graven image?
So that's a graven image. That's something that was made with man's hand. It's a graven image. Go ahead.
That the maker thereof hath graven it.
Uh-huh.
The molten image and a teacher of lies.
What is it?
And a teacher of lies.
What is it?
And a teacher of lies.
And it's a teacher of lies. Go ahead.
That the maker of his work trusted therein to make dumb idols.
To do what?
To make dumb idols.
To make dumb idols. Right? So these are idols that man literally made with their hands. And then they put it, and then they sell it to you. And then you buy, you participate in it. But it's a teacher of lies. Because what does that cross represent? Christianity. People see that cross, they say he's a Christian. You understand what I'm saying? And we know they don't teach the truth. Right? So, give me another question. It's about you right now. Last man standing. How you get the kingdom of heaven?
Following God, obeying God's rule.
What's gonna happen if you don't keep the commandment?
If you don't keep the commandment,
What's gonna happen to these 12 tribes if they decide
we're not making it to heaven?
Huh?
We're not gonna make it to heaven.
Where is heaven? Huh? Where you want to go? Where is heaven going to be at? Where is that at? Huh? You got Chris up? Yeah, you can bring that up.
This is the book of Matthew chapter 6 and verse number 9.
Bring it out.
After this manner therefore pray ye, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth.
Where?
In earth.
So where's the kingdom of heaven going? Earth, right here. What a white man kingdom is? Right here. This is his kingdom. Right? Go ahead.
As it is in heaven.
As what?
As it is in heaven.
Everything you see here is just a reflection of what's above the firmament anyway. You understand what I'm saying? So bring this out. You got it? Revelation 21.
Time. Book of Revelation chapter 21.
Start at 9.
No, you can start at where you start at 1.
The book of Revelation chapter 21 and verse 1.
Bring it out!
And I saw a new heaven and a new earth.
Keep going.
Come on. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven.
Out of what?
Out of heaven.
Where did it come? It came down. Go ahead.
Con. Prepare as a bride adorned for her husband.
And this, what is this talking about? This is actually talking about the people. Right? That's why the Lord said the kingdom of heaven is within you. We are the kingdom of heaven. You see what I'm saying? Wherever we are, that's the kingdom of heaven. Right? So we're going to come down out of those chariots. All right? And I'm like, give me Isaiah 60. Right? And we're going to link it all up. We're going to show you the real gospel. First, give me Luke 4 and 18. All right? Because right now, this is the so-called white man's kingdom.
Bring it out.
You understand? This is Esau's world and his kingdom that we suffer in. You understand? But we have a kingdom that's coming. Read that.
Kind. Verse 3, and I heard a great voice.
And we're going to show you what it looked like, and we're going to show you how it's going to happen. And we're going to show you what the Lord is going to do and how he's going to bring it to pass. If you repent and you stay on the path and follow into the straight gate. Read.
Kind. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them. And they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God.
Now jump down to verse 12.
Verse 12. And had a wall great and high. And had a wall great and high.
And had a wall great. So the kingdom of heaven is going to have a wall great and high. You know, like the white man trying to build a wall to keep the Hispanics out of here.
Yeah.
They don't want, what they call them?
Wetbacks.
They got a name. Oh, no.
Immigrants.
Immigrants.
Immigrants. Oh, okay, Salak.
The white man want to build a wall up and keep the people out. He stole their land. And he want to build a wall. He's the alien. The white people are illegal immigrants.
They're down terror.
They came over here and slaughtered our people and stole his land. The Native American Seminole Indians. So listen to this.
Con.
Because we're going to have a wall in our kingdom. Oh. Read.
Revelation chapter 21, verse 12.
Bring
and
it
had
out.
A wall great and high. And had 12 gates.
One big pearly gate.
And had 12 gates.
How many gates?
And had 12 gates.
How many gates in the kingdom of heaven? Why is that not one gate for everybody? Why are there 12 gates?
There you learn it.
That's right. You smart. Put a 12 tribe because they don't have a kingdom. They live in the ghettos in the slums. They were scattered. They were enslaved. They had their names taken. Their language taken. They called black. This is black.
Yep.
They called niggas. That's not our name.
Bring it up.
But God said there's gonna be 12 gates in the kingdom. Read.
Con. And at the gates, 12 angels.
And what?
And at the gates, 12 angels.
See, they'd have stayed if we'd have stayed.
yeah, that's
true. Ain't on the list.
I guess they came up here. They thought it was something sweet. This is not the Christian church, man.
Right?
Yeah, it would have been Edomite. Yeah. And that's that guilt. The Bible says shame shall cover them.
Because
he know what they did. They don't want to deal with it. Go ahead, God.
And names written thereon.
And it's names on these gates. Read.
Which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel.
What is Pastor talking about?
Get out.
What are these niggas that sitting in the church with his bald head, sweating his back out? What are they doing? They just stepping fetching for the white man.
Ha.
Just steady pushing the white man what he learned from Mouse that's been passed down to them. The Bible don't say none of that. That's why they never had a Bible. They got about 4 or 5 scriptures that they all read. John 3:16. Oh, Malachi. What it said? Bring all your tithes to the storehouse. You understand? Will a man rob God? Right, Pastor, trying to get that new Bentley, man.
Give you a couple Proverbs and a couple songs.
Yeah.
That's it.
And then the choir come on and sing.
Yeah.
No, this whole book is our history book, man.
That's right.
You understand?
Yeah.
So now, what else I call? Read that. John 14.
This is the book of John. Chapter 14 and verse 1.
You know,
let not your heart be troubled.
Hold on. It's a lot in that, but we're gonna just jump down just to give you a glimpse, you know what I'm saying? Of the difference, you know what I'm saying? Verse right down to Esau, he built his kingdom with them cement. You know what I'm saying? Back hurting. It ain't nothing but a big ass cave. Right, because the so-called white man came from caves and mountains, right? That's why every city got skyline. Our kingdom not going to be like this. You understand? Read that.
Con. First, Revelation chapter 21, verse 21.
Bring it out!
And the 12 gates were 12 pearls.
Right. But what?
Were 12 pearls.
It's not just any type of gates. It's not going to be metal. It's not going to be like that gate right there.
It's tombs,
you know what I'm saying? It's going to be pearls, man.
Right.
Imagine if the white man's kingdom go around the world and see some beautiful things, man, he got set up. It's beautiful. We desire to have that. Imagine how our kingdom's going to be. Because the Lord going to melt and tear all this down. And the white man going to build up our kingdom. I'm going to show you that. Just like we built this place up.
Yep.
Now listen to this. Read.
Con.
And that's going to be heavy, man. The pearls. And it's going to be heavy. That pure gold.
Yeah.
They gonna work hard, man.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
God. Every several gate.
Like
yeah, yeah.
They're not gonna have these machines running on gas and fuel and all that, man. They gonna have to come together and figure it out, man. The Lord said we're gonna rule them with a rod. Give me Revelation 2 and 26. Read that.
God. Every several gate was of one pearl, and the street of the city was pure gold.
Wait a minute, what are our streets gonna be?
Was pure gold.
The streets of our city's gonna be pure gold.
Woo!
Ice.
Not like the gold here, I'm talking about pure, real gold. Like Solomon's gold. You understand what I'm saying? Our streets are gonna be pure gold, brothers. Don't worry about this, is temporary. Don't worry about this. You understand? Brother, imagine that. Can you imagine that? Pure gold streets. Brother, you don't even know how to walk on gold, brother. You can't walk regular. You got to, you know what I'm saying? You got to have a different walk, man. You know what I'm saying? Oh, let go, man. Go ahead.
God, as it were transparent glass.
As what?
As it were transparent glass.
It's going to be so icy, it's going to be like, you're going to be able to see yourself.
Come.
Jacob be. You know what I'm saying? In that gold, man. Ain't gonna be like your grill, brother. This is a different type of gold, man, in this kingdom. Go ahead.
God. And I saw no
That's it on that. Bring this out.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 2 and verse 27.
Bring it out.
And he shall rule them with a rod of iron.
And he shall what?
And he shall rule them with a rod of iron.
He's gonna rule them with a rod of iron, man. You understand? Don't the white man rule us with his gun, right? When the police pull up, the only advantage you got, we know he got that gun on his hood, right. And he got backup. You understand? That white boy take that damn uniform off and pull up with all that, he gonna get beat the hell up.
Beat
you know what I'm saying? All that confidence gonna go down the drain, because they really afraid of us. So we gonna rule them with a rod of iron. Go ahead.
As the vessels of a potter, shall they be broken to shivers.
Shall what?
Shall they be broken to shivers.
You ever seen a plate or a vase hit the ground and just... Yeah. That's how we gonna be doing it. We gonna be breaking them, man. Didn't they break us? Didn't they butt break us? Didn't they beat our backs in? No, we ain't doing that.
Yeah, right.
You know what I'm saying? Let's be clear about that. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
I'm just saying it's justified. Yeah, go ahead.
Even as I received of my Father, and I will give him the morning star. He that hath an ear, let him hear that the Spirit saith unto the churches.
Now go to, give me John.
This is the book of John.
Where you live at, brother?
Okay.
Live in the house? Apartment?
House.
Live in the house?
Yeah.
Where you live? Is it big? How many floors in your house?
Nah, one floor.
Just one floor? You only got one floor? Damn. How many rooms you got in there?
I'm staying with my mom right now.
Staying with your mom, bro? Sorry, brother. Stay with your mom right now, man. Hey.
The lease was up.
Lease was up. Now you gotta find another white man to ask him, can we live over there?
Yeah.
Right? You gotta come up with a deposit.
Yep.
First and last month rent. You gonna check your credit, you know what I'm saying? You gotta call somebody, you gotta try to finesse the game. Where you live at, brother? Live in a house, apartment? You live right here?
Ooh, you one of them type of niggas?
You live right here?
In this area, yeah.
Oh, I thought you said right here. You live somewhere around here?
Yeah, it's close to here.
Okay, apartment?
Yeah.
House, apartment? How many rooms you got in there?
Just
two. Two? You only got two rooms? So you can go over here and go over here, that's it.
It's pretty small, yeah.
Pretty small, man.
Damn. We're waking our way up.
And our foreparents picked $7 trillion for us. What about you, bro? I know you got a big, nice house. You living good, bro.
You know what you living?
Where you live? You got a house?
A house.
How many bedrooms? Three bedrooms? How many floors? One floor, two? You got one floor? Damn. Don't worry about it. Listen to this.
Get out.
This is my
first John.
John chapter 14 from the top.
There you go.
Let not your heart be troubled.
Don't let your heart be troubled about your two-bedroom house. Right? We broke the commandments. It's our sins, man. We were brought here in America not to prosper, not to be successful, but to repent. Right? Go ahead. Not saying that brothers can't be blessed and have good things. Right? That's fine. Read.
Ye believe in God.
You believe in God? Y'all believe in God? Read. Four.
Believe also in me.
If you believe in God, then you believe in his son? You believe in his son, right? All right, read.
In my father's house.
Well, as the Lord said, in his father's house, which is the kingdom of heaven. All right, this is the white man's house right here. In the white man's house, we live in the hood with roaches, two-bedroom apartments, right. where they will shit break, and then they don't come for a long time to come fix it. Right? Where they can cut your water off if you late on your water bill. You understand? Right? But God said in his father's house, read.
Or many mansions.
Apartments.
Or many mansions.
Townhouses.
Or many mansions.
Regular houses.
Or many mansions.
Hotels.
Or many mansions.
What's that place where the homeless go? Shelters.
Or mini mansions.
Or mini mansions. You understand? There's not going to be apartment complexes in the Kingdom of Heaven.
Nope.
It's not going to be a need for.
Nah.
There's not going to be a such thing as a credit check. You don't need credit in the Kingdom of Heaven. You're getting your credit score up right now by keeping the commandments.
That's right.
By repenting. By separating yourself from the world. Go ahead.
If it were so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you.
What the Lord say?
I go to prepare a place for you.
Notice, there's a mansion in the Kingdom of Heaven where streets are made of gold and pearly gates. All right? For you.
Right.
This is temporary.
Right.
That's why the Lord said, he that shall endure. We endure these things. We deal with it.
That's
it is
right.
What it is. Let the white man live good. Because I work where he live at. You understand? And it's nice. But it's not to be compared to what God has for us. Give me the book of Luke chapter 4 and verse 18. Let's go into the gospel.
That's right. This is the book of Luke chapter 4 and verse number 17.
Read it out.
And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written.
So the book of Isaiah, which we got right here, was handed to Christ. He went to a specific place. Read.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel.
Y'all know what gospel means? Because Christianity in the world teaches us that the Bible, the gospel is for everybody. You know what gospel means? You know what it means?
Gospel?
Yeah.
Preaching?
Huh?
Word?
Uh-uh. You know what gospel means?
I don't.
Gospel means glad tidings or good news. So good, who needs good news? Who always getting bad news?
Us.
Everybody don't need good news. Everything is good for some people already. The gospel has to be taught. It's gonna tell you who needs the gospel. Read. We need some damn good news.
Yeah.
Read.
To preach the gospel to the poor.
To who?
To the poor.
Who's the poor? The 12 tribes are the poor. As a nation. Just because we got a LeBron James and a Michael Jordan, that don't mean, as a nation, as a whole, we are the poor. The gospel is for the poor. Read.
He have sent me to heal the brokenhearted.
Who's the brokenhearted? Right?
That's right.
Who always got to bury their son? Who always got to march and sing and cry? Who always getting their heart broke? Let me see. Who the brokenhearted, man? Who went through this, man? Read.
To preach deliverance.
Wait a minute. To do, what is the gospel?
To preach deliverance.
Who needs deliverance? Does the oppressor need deliverance? Or the oppressed need deliverance from an oppressor? Right, somebody need to be saved from somebody else. Salvation being for everybody is, God would be unjust. That don't make no sense, God. What you mean? It's like you being raped by somebody. And you call for help and they come save both of y'all together. No, the rape victim need to be saved from the rapist. That's salvation. Read.
To preach deliverance.
Listen, for the white man to be, if the white man, I don't even want to go to the kingdom if the white man wants to. For the white people to go into the kingdom together with us, it ain't right. It don't make no sense. He built this whole kingdom on our backs. He could just say, I'm sorry and repent.
I'll forgive you, bro.
That ain't fair. That ain't, we didn't ever enslave him. We didn't do nothing to them. Read.
To preach deliverance to the captives.
Wait a minute. Hold on. To the who?
To the captives.
Was white people captives? Or were they the captors?
Captains.
They were the captors. They enslaved us. They put us in captivity.
That's right.
So the gospel is for the captors. I mean for the captives. Yeah. The captives need to be set free. Physically, mentally, spiritually, from the lies, from the deceit, from religion, from GMO foods, from poison water, from crack, from weed, from homosexuality, from all this stuff this man has set up and magnified this world and life of sin that is placed before us.
That's right.
It's politics. It's fake democracy.
Debt.
Go ahead. Go. We'll forever hold a white man. I ain't paying them nothing back. I ain't paying them nothing back, bro. I'll tell you that right now. I give a damn about a credit score. Go ahead.
And recover of sight to the blind.
Hey, y'all. Y'all was blind, now y'all can see a little bit. Things make a little more sense now when it comes to the Bible and life. That's recovering the sight to the blind. We were blind, but now we see. You understand? This is real healing, man.
That's right.
We was blind and couldn't see. I thought the white man was my friend. Some of these white people don't even know. It's spiritual.
Spiritual indeed.
Read.
To set at liberty.
Pills, man.
Spirit.
Spirit, he kind of walking through, man. Lord, show you the enemy. As soon as we said it, damn Esau appeared.
That's
right.
Yeah.
He don't go through what, he don't have a care in the world, man. He don't go through what we got to go through. Read, that man, I'm telling you right now, he ain't worried about his rent getting paid. That man rent is paid throughout for the rest of the year.
To set at liberty them that are bruised.
Who is bruised? To set at liberty them that are bruised. Who is bruised?
Trust,
man. Read.
To preach the acceptable year of the Lord.
Who's waiting on the Lord to come back? Is the white, you think the white, and we, when we show you what Christ is going to do when he come back, see, they'll have you thinking Christ coming back hugging everybody. The Lord, Jesus going to come back and he just going to give everybody a hug.
Give you a crown.
Yeah, just get ready, come on, you get one, you get down, Oprah. No, you think the white man wants the Lord to come back and do what he's going to do to his kingdom that he built up? These white people don't want their America to be destroyed. They love America. They still waving that bloody ass flag. Read.
And he closed the book.
And he closed the book. So let's go. Read that.
Isaiah chapter 61 from the top. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me.
And you see, in Isaiah, it's saying the same thing. That it's a. So in Christianity, they say that's the Old Testament. Oh, close that. Stay in the New Testament. But Christ himself went to the Old Testament to show you what the good news was. Why? Because it was already prophesied to happen.
Right.
Read it.
God, because the Lord had anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek.
Y'all are the meek. God anointed us to teach y'all the glorious gospel unto the meek. Y'all didn't plan this, man. When y'all woke up this morning, y'all had no idea y'all be standing out here all day listening to some crazy-ass niggas out here saying some absurd stuff, talking crazy. No. The Lord ordered your steps today. Come on.
God, he had sent me to bind up the brokenhearted.
God sent us out here. We don't get paid for this. This brother back hurt. Brothers on their feet. We got jobs too. We were sent to bind up the brokenhearted, man. To gather our people one at a time. Not big, huge crowd. The Lord said, few gonna be saved.
That's right.
Everybody, 2/3 of our people gotta die.
That's right.
Because they love the white man, they love America, they love the world. We can't take them with us.
Right.
They'll be in the damn kingdom cooning out. You know what I'm saying? Ask them, what about the white? We ain't trying to hear that, man. Right. Get them away from me, bro.
Right.
So the Lord's going to have to kill 2/3 of our people because
right.
They not going to repent. They don't want to separate from the world. This thing is about separation. Didn't Christ say, I come not to bring peace but a sword? The Lord not coming for peace. This ain't about peace. It ain't never been about peace. It's always been about division. It's about peace for us. Come on.
Time to proclaim.
Hey, the white man ain't getting no peace in our kingdom.
Nope.
Cause he coming too. He gonna be in our kingdom just like we in his kingdom. And he ain't getting no peace, he ain't getting no rest, day nor night.
Nope.
Except on the Sabbath. Go ahead.
God, to proclaim liberty to the captives.
So freedom and liberty to the slaves. Come on.
God, and to the opening.
Liberty was not the white man letting us off the plantation to go get a job. He didn't need us no more on the plantation. We picked all the goddamn cut.
Bring it out.
He done killed enough of us. Now I need these niggas. Now I'm setting up sports events. Somebody need to spend my money. I need somebody to go work my job and continue to build up my nation. Because when he give you a little check, just enough, guess where you got to take it back to?
You got to give it back to them. So who got to make the money? Nobody spends more money than us. We spending up all the money. He's saving his money. He's sitting on money. That's why they have wealth that they pass down and down. Everything comes in our pocket, goes right back. Give me Haggai 1 and 6, I believe. Give me Haggai 1 and 6.
This is the book of Haggai.
Your pastor will never read the book. I've never, all my life in church, I've never heard, I didn't even know it was a book of Haggai. I've never heard pastor go to Haggai. Read.
Man, this is the book of
Haggai. Hey, I put Haggai one time, and niggas like, what you read?
I that's never the Bible? Heard that.
Nigga, is that the Bible, nigga? What is you niggas? You niggas is Muslims? Haggai, read that.
This is the book of Haggai, chapter 1 and verse 6.
Bring it out.
Ye have sown much and bring in little.
We do a lot. We work hard as hell. We built this place. And we bring in little, we ain't got a damn thing, man. We can't win for losing. We can't say, we can't get ahead. Come on.
Ye eat, but ye have not enough.
We eat, but we don't got enough. Come on.
Ye drink, but ye are not filled with drink.
We drink, but we not filled with drink. It's not enough. Come on.
Ye clothe you, but there's none war.
Come on.
And he that earneth wages.
And you that earn money, read.
Earneth wages to put into a bag with holes.
That's like you getting your check and you got a hole in your pocket. That's what the Bible say. When I send you to that white boy, since you don't want to serve me, I'm going to send you to that white boy. He going to give you a check and you're going to put it in a bag with holes in it. Where my money?
Damn,
I just got paid. So now I got to wait 2 more weeks. Damn, I got to wait 2 more weeks to get another check. It's already gone. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. Read. Kind. White man don't wait on no check.
We all check.
And that thing going into his kids got trust funds. All type of stuff set up, right? Read.
Kind. And the opening of the prison to them that are bound.
And the opening of the prison to them that are bound. We bound. We bound mentally. Come on.
Kind. Verse 2. To proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance.
Wait a minute. I thought, there's a day of vengeance? What is vengeance?
Get out.
If God loves everybody, he's coming in just to save. What is this vengeance? Vengeance is revenge.
Yeah, revenge.
Payback. For what? What is it payback for? Who got to get paid back? Come on.
Kind.
They get it. Let's go.
And the damn vengeance of our God to come
the forth. Vengeance of our God. Because we don't got the white man, white boy, that white boy got a military. That white boy got an army. That white boy got a navy. That white boy got a space force. That white boy got an air force. That white boy got a damn, what's it called? Border Patrol. National Guard. That white boy got the Marines.
Coast Guard.
That white boy got Coast Guard. He got bombs. Unlimited. What we got? We ain't got nothing. We just got a nigga just talk about what he gonna do. Man, all we got is a bunch of damn niggas talking shit all goddamn day. We ain't got nothing gonna do nothing. We ain't got nothing. But guess what we do? We have an army. Okay? We got the host of the heavens, the angels. And those UFOs, they call them UFOs, those chariots, we're gonna show you. Those chariots that they send, okay? In those vehicles, and those are angels of God. That's our army that they fear. That's coming back to destroy this place. I'm gonna show you all that, read.
Kind, to comfort all that mourn, to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion.
That mourn in the world.
That mourn in Zion.
Anybody that mourn in anywhere.
That mourn in Zion.
Wait a minute, the gospel and the good news and salvation is for them that's mourning and suffering in Zion. Who is Zion? Y'all. Zion is another name for Israel.
Get out.
The Israelites.
Right.
Come on.
God. To give unto them beautiful ashes.
God gonna give us beauty for ashes. Come on.
The oil of joy for mourning.
Uh-huh.
And the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness.
Uh-huh.
That they might be called trees of righteousness.
Give me Revelation 21 and 4. So the Lord say he gonna give you the oil of gladness, man. You understand? For mourning and the sorrow and all the pain and everything we went through, that's going to be healing. right? It's like you got a wound and you put that ointment on it. That's what the Lord gonna do. Read that.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 21 and verse 4.
Read it out.
And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. And there shall be no more death.
That shall what?
And there shall be no more death.
Because we're gonna be immortal. We the only people that's gonna be immortal. All that, that's what everything he making his movies he got from us. He telling you our story. That ain't real, but it's real for us. Ain't gonna be no more. The white man can't kill you no more. You understand, brother? We are the children of the power.
That's right.
Read.
Neither sorrow.
It's not gonna be a such thing as sorrow. Right now we got mental illness, sorrow of heart, sorrow of mind, man. We deal with these things, man. Wondering why our father wasn't there, man. We wanna help mama. We never got, she died. We got so much stuff we deal with, man. We got so many goals and plans and things we wanna do, man. Things we suffering from, man. So much regret. You understand? Things happened to us when we was young, man. And we just holding in, nobody know. So much pain and hurt and sorrow that's within us. When you see that man and he going crazy, man, you don't know that man pain, what he been through.
Yeah.
And they say this man, they talk bad about him. All they see is what happened and what he did. They don't know what he went through and what happened. He reached his breaking point. You understand? And they put the report out there. They say he just shot up the goddamn. No, he didn't. He didn't just wake up and go down.
Shoot.
Yeah, and shoot the damn dog. What's the brother, man, Dorner? The brother, man, that was killing all the police, man? Yeah, that wasn't just, you know what I'm saying? They don't know, they didn't go reach that. It's a story out there, what happened. You understand what I'm saying? And nobody care about that. And this nigga went crazy. Go ahead.
Nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain.
Neither what?
Neither shall there be any more pain.
We're not gonna know what pain feels like. Imagine that, not to know what pain. There's not gonna be a such thing as a headache in the kingdom of heaven. They don't have stomach aches. It's gonna be impossible for you to hit your damn toe. You ever got up in the middle of the night and try to go to the kitchen and hit your damn toe? Ain't no such thing as that. It's gonna be impossible to trip and fall. Read.
For the former things are passed away. Verse 5. And he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new.
What the Lord say?
I make all things new.
What the Lord say?
I make all things new.
Read.
And he said unto me, write, for these words are true.
What are they?
Are true.
No, it's just a fairy tale.
Are true.
Nigga, dream on.
Are true.
These words are true. And we know that. The Lord said in this book, we were going to slavery on ships. Did it happen?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what happened. So the Lord said he's going to save you, take your pain away, give you immortality, give you a kingdom with streets made of gold and mansions and rulership. Is he going to do that too?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's going to do it. Read on.
Con. That they might be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he may glorify. Verse 4. That they shall build up the old waste place.
Wait a minute. Hold on now. What verse was you at? Yeah, read verse 4.
Con. That they shall build up the old waste.
Who? Who is they? There you go. This brother been on fire all night. They gonna build up the old ways, Reed.
That they shall rise up the former desolation and shall repair the waste city, the desolation of many generations, and strangers shall stand and feed your flock.
Wait, now we gonna feed our own flock.
And strangers shall stand and feed your flock.
Now we gonna work in our own field.
And strangers shall stand and feed your flocks.
Who are the strangers? They gonna feed our flocks. You understand? They gonna work in our fields. Read on.
Con. And the sons of aliens shall be your plowmen.
Wait a minute, we're gonna be our plowmen.
And the sons of aliens shall be your plowmen.
And any work that needs to be done, who gonna do it? We're not working no more. Whatever work you doing now and everything, whatever we gotta do now, that's it. Go on and do it with joyfulness and gladness while you keep the commandments. And that's what endurance is, you endure. Do what you gotta do. But that's it. Ain't no more work after this.
That's right.
Get a white man that. Let him have it. Now look at that devil. I got to look at my boss at work. I said, I understand it's all you're going to get. You understand? And when I pray, I ask the Lord. I got some specific white people throughout my life, and I ask the Lord to give them. I want them in the kingdom. Right? I want the Lord to preserve them. Don't kill them. Keep them alive. And when we get in our kingdom, I want them to be my slaves. You understand?
God.
So I'm at work, and I'm looking at my boss, and I want him to be my slave in the kingdom. You know what I'm saying? And I do a good job on my job. I work hard on my job. You understand? I work hard on purpose. You know what I'm saying? And while I'm working, in my mind, I'm praying to the Lord. Give me Psalms 2 and 8. Real quick. I'm asking him. I want that devil. His name is David. I want David. I call him by name. I need David in the kingdom, man. I gotta have him, man. Read
this
that.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 2 and verse 8.
Bring it out.
Ask of me.
Do what?
Ask of me.
You may say I'm wrong for this. You may say, come on, brother, then you're going too far. You ask it, God to give you. What did God say?
Ask of me.
Brother, I don't ask for a new car. I'm not asking to get rich. I'm not asking for the Lord to make 2024 my year. I'm not asking for that. I'm asking for my boss to be my slave in the kingdom.
Right. That's right. And I shall give thee the heathen for thine inheritance.
I want to inherit that white boy.
That's right.
I want the Lord to add David to my inheritance.
That's right.
God told me to ask for it.
Come.
He wants to give it to you.
That's right.
God said, come on, brother. Come on, bro. Come on, bro. You got to give me some, bro. Come on, go ahead.
In the uttermost parts of the earth for thy possession.
In the whole earth for our possession. Because the Lord made the whole earth for us.
Right.
This whole earth is really ours, man. This tree, that's your tree, brother. That a building that you live in, that was built with your possession. We are literally paying for our own stuff.
Right.
Read.
Verse 9. Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron.
No, that's not rub their back.
Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron.
We're going to give them hugs.
Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron.
We're going to love on them.
Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron.
We're going to be breaking their ass down, man. They did too much. That's what it means, the vengeance, we're going to get our revenge. Give me Ezekiel 25 and 14.
This is the book. Right, Ezekiel, chapter 25.
What we're reading to you is prophecy, eschatology, things that are going to happen. None of this stuff has happened yet. Come on.
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 25 and verse 14.
Bring it out.
And I will lay my vengeance upon Edom.
Who is Edom? God is going to get revenge on Edom. We Israel, who's Edom? That's right, they're the Edomites. Edom.
By the hand of my people.
Hold on, how is he going to do it?
By the hand of my people.
Who is God's people? Give me Psalms 44 and 1. By the hands of his people.
Israel.
Who?
Israel.
So God is going to get vengeance on a white man. How?
In the hands of Israel.
Yeah. So who's going to do it?
Us.
That's right. Break it down. We're going to fight. That's why we're telling our people, separate from the white man. You see what I'm saying? Now is the time of separation. The Lord said, gather yourselves together.
That's right.
Race wars are coming.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? The Lord going to get bent. That's why they hate you. They know it's coming. That's why they plotting and scheming. They teaching their kids how to shoot. Go on YouTube.
Yeah.
These white people are preparing their children and practicing for these last days, mm-hmm. for the end time. Yeah. They know what's coming. Jake's sitting there playing PlayStation all day. Rolling up blunts. Yeah, that. They at the right. Man, it's this little white Edomite, man. He's rolling up. He hitting every bing, 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 bing. That's their gift, is the
Edomite
sword.
Girl, too.
But see, our people are going to be, they're going to kill, I'm sorry to say it, they're going to kill the hell out of our people. These white women that's married to the white man, they're going to end up in their trunk. The white man going to eat them when the famine, when there's no food.
Yeah.
The Lord going to put a spirit of Esau back in the earth, and he's going to put the spirit back on us. The righteous, the God is going to be with us. We don't have the military might to stand toe-to-toe with this devil. You understand? You're going to need God on your side. That's why we're compelling you, brothers, to repent, keep the commandments, and come get on this side.
Right.
You understand? Come stand with us.
Right.
Because we on God's side. God is with us, man.
Right.
Read.
And they shall do in Edom according to my anger.
We ain't even that mad. God is gonna put his anger in us. Right? Imagine God put his anger on you right now. Brother, you might just, next thing you know, you 7'5". You know what I'm saying? Damn smoke coming out your ears, man. A damn sword, a double-edged sword, a gold sword appearing in your head. All of a sudden, you know how to work a sword. You ain't never used a sword before. All of a sudden, you ever seen, what's that Will Smith movie, man?
Wait, son.
Hancock.
Oh, yeah, Hancock.
Yo, we literally gonna be picking up Edomite and throwing their ass from here to Jamaica, man. Real talk, they think it's funny, man. I'm serious, man.
Nah, it's real.
Go ahead.
And according to my fury.
And according to God's fury, man.
And they shall know my vengeance, saith the Lord God.
And they gonna know his vengeance. Finish that. Yeah, get that. Yo, go ahead, read that.
Isaiah chapter.
Give me 60 and 14.
Isaiah chapter 60, verse 14.
Bring it out.
The sons also of them that afflict thee.
Who are the sons of those that afflicted us? He didn't say the people that afflicted us. He didn't say the slave master that had the whip in our forefathers' back. They had children. And our forefathers that got beat, they had children. And looking at us today, we're the generation that's here today. They benefit from slavery, we still suffer from it. The so-called white man, if I drive you to the bank and I get out and go rob, if you drive me to the bank and I get out and go rob the bank, are you going to jail too? He gonna say you're an accessory, but you didn't do nothing. So the white man say they didn't do it, but guess what? They eating all, they benefit from it. They still using slave money, right? Geico, right? No, Wells Fargo, sense. All these banks, they were set up by slave money.
Chase.
Still to this day, Chase Bank, Bank of America. Well, yeah, all these banks, that's our money.
Yeah.
Just because they put the white boy face on it, they in debt, they really owe us. We owe God restoration. That's why we suffer. We repent from our sins and we endure this ass whooping. You understand? And we be grateful that the Lord could just delete us and just got rid of us. Mm-hmm. But he had love, and he sent his son, and his son was bruised for our iniquities. So we were sent here to change our ways and repent to be a light unto the world. You understand? Go ahead.
Con. The sons also of them that afflict thee.
All right, so these white people that afflicted us, read.
Shall come bending unto thee.
Shall what?
Shall come bending unto thee.
He's gonna come bending unto us, man. Give me Revelation 3 and 9. Go ahead.
Con. And all they that despise thee.
And all that despise, I hate these niggas. All these Karens and Kens, all that despise us. Go ahead.
Con. Shall bow themselves down at the sole of thy feet.
Shall do what?
Shall bow themselves down at the soles of thy feet.
They gonna bow down. They won't do it now. Right? But in that day, they gonna do it. They don't have no choice.
Yeah.
Read.
Con. And they shall call thee the city of the Most High, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel.
The what?
The Zion of the Holy One of Israel.
Read.
Con. Whereas thou hast forsaken and hate, so that no man went through thee, I will make thee an eternal excellence, a joy of many generations.
Yeah.
Come. Verse 16. Thou shalt also suck the milk of the Gentiles. Thou shalt suck the breast of kings.
Read that slow. Slow down.
Verse 16.
So all the everything that they we basically gonna rob them. All right.
To borrow stuff.
Really not, because we just taking our stuff back. Right. We running down on them. we need all that back. You understand? Go ahead.
Con. Isaiah chapter 60 verse 16.
Bring it out.
Thou shalt also suck the milk of the Gentiles, and thou shalt suck the breast of kings. And those
like Donald Trump, all these kings, all these mighty men. Go ahead.
Con. And thou shalt know that the Most High am thy Savior.
And what?
I'm thy Savior.
They gonna know that God is our Savior. They gonna know that he was our Savior. Not this white boy they gave us. This damn white Jesus, where he at? That damn devil. He gonna be in there too.
Over there.
Where he at? Bring him here. Father. There you go. Come here, devil. See, this white boy, he tried to say that this was, he tried to tell us this is our Savior. And I always say, you know how many of y'all people, all grandma and them praying to this with this image in their mind? Thinking a white man coming to save them? Crying? Hey, it's a video on, yeah, these black women just crying to white Jesus, man. They had like a little fake white Jesus coming through there, man, and they leaning. It's sad, man. It makes you want to cry. And this is a loss. This devil right here, man, this white boy, man, that's not Jesus. Give me the other one right here. This is what he really looks like. That's what the Bible says. Not this, but he white boy wasn't gonna give you this. He gonna give you that. This is why niggas shoot and kill each other and afraid of the white man. You understand? Because they look at the white man as if he's God, and they look at you as a person and nigga. It's spiritual. Imagery is everything. You understand? Go ahead. That's why I gotta go down like this. Give me
Isaiah 14 and 1. What I got to go?
Go to Revelation 3 and 9 real quick. You're going to rush.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 3 and verse 9.
Bring it out.
Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not.
Who say they do? We call ourselves Jews or niggas? Niggas. Who call themselves Jews? Esau, Edomite. He don't want to be Edom no more. He's an imposter. He's a fugitive. The Bible calls him a fugitive and a vagabond. What do fugitives do when they're on the run from the police? They change their hair, they change their name, they steal somebody's identity. They hide it.
Come.
All these white people are hiding. They on the run from God. You understand? Because they touch the apple of God's eye. Give me Zephaniah 3 and 9 real quick. Click on the screen. Zephaniah 3 and 9. So they're on the run because they know vengeance is coming, judgment is coming somewhere around the corner. They just don't know when. You understand?
Yeah. The book of Zephaniah, chapter 3.
I'm
there. Bring it out. Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 9.
Bring it out.
For then will I turn to the people of pure language.
No. That's Zephaniah. Zechariah. Zechariah 3 and 9.
Book of Zechariah, chapter 2 and verse 8. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, after the glory hath he sent me unto the nations, which spoiled you.
What nation spoiled us? You're going to find out. It wasn't just the white man. All these nations did. The Arabs, the Chinese man, every nation under the earth enslaved us. Come on.
For he that toucheth you.
He that toucheth the Israelites, who touched us? All of them touched us. They had a sub-Saharan slave. It wasn't just a transatlantic slave trade.
Right.
He had a Silk Road slave trade. Right? You had during the time of Nebuchadnezzar. You had the Assyrians. Even the Egyptians. Right? The Romans. The Greeks. Read.
Toucheth the apple of his eye.
What does God call these brothers?
Toucheth the apple of his eye.
What does God call our people?
Toucheth the apple of his eye.
When they oppressed us, they touched the apple of God's eye.
Come on.
So what you'll do right now, somebody come down in your damn eye. Ain't gonna get mad. He ain't gonna like that. Imagine somebody do it to God. That's what they did to the Lord. Imagine you do that to the greatest power, the power of all powers, man. Damn. You know what I'm saying? Bring it out. Go back. Yeah.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 3 and verse 9.
Bring it out.
Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews.
We don't say we Jews. We the real Jews, but we don't say we Jews. We call ourselves niggas. Black. Read.
And are not.
So it's talking about the so-called white man who call himself Jewish, who stole your identity. And what?
But do
really
lie.
And are not.
That say they are Jews and are not.
Who the Bible says whoever called himself Jews in the last days ain't really the Jews. They lying. Because the real Jews not supposed to know who they are.
That's right.
We supposed to come out here and teach them. Right? That's what the gospel, that's the good news. You a Jew, nigga. Salvation is for you.
That's right.
It's going to be all right. You see what I'm
right.
saying? The Lord going to bring them. Better days are coming. Right? Read.
But do lie.
But what?
But do lie.
White man is a liar. Read.
Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet.
That's the part of your inheritance and your reward. The Lord said they're going to come and worship before your feet. They're going to bow down before you and worship you. Read.
And to know that I have loved thee.
And to know that God actually loved you. Because our people don't know that. Our people think God only loves white people. And we got to get in where we fit in. We better be good to Massa and white people if we want God to love us. Because Jesus is white. Oh, but it don't matter what he look like. When we tell them, now it's to the point we tell our people he look like them. It don't matter about the color. Y'all racist. But nobody got a problem with this white boy sitting up on everybody's wall across the world. You Google Jesus, this is going to come up. Imagine that, man. Imagine you've been a great man. Right? Great man. And hundreds and thousands of years later, all your people think you are Eric. You don't even look like you no more. You look like something else. Would that bother you? Yeah, that'll bother you, man. So the Lord, when the Lord come back, man, the Lord will be upset, man. Lord, come back. Lord, this man was a homosexual, man. You know what I'm saying? Look what they did to the Lord, man. He got a damn mullet. Right? That's madness. That's disrespectful, man.
Leprosy.
Yeah, he got leprosy, man. And the law, that's white skin, white people, that's leprosy in the law. That's uncleanliness, man. To look like that. Go ahead. What else you got to look?
Yeah. It's the book of Joel. This is going back to when the brothers were trying to explain to y'all that the children of Israel are going to be like superheroes in that day. Yeah. It's the book of Joel, chapter 2 and verse 4.
Bring it out!
The appearance of them is the appearance of horses, and as a horseman, so shall they run, like the noise of chariots on the tops of mountains.
You ever seen a horse run? Can you beat a horse running? Horse.
That day.
But in that day, when we're running down on East Side, it's gonna be like horses running out though, man.
Yeah.
You understand? Go ahead.
On the tops of mountains shall they leap.
Wait a minute.
Leap mountains?
Y'all don't believe in the Bible, man. Y'all don't believe in the Bible. You believe in the Bible, brother? Do you believe you're gonna be able to leap over a mountain?
Yeah.
What about you, brother? But you don't believe that. You believe it? Go ahead.
Like the noise of a flame of fire that devours the stubble.
Oh, you think that's where they get there? They got Superman down. They got damn Spider-Man down going across the goddamn light pole. Spinning around on that. You know what I'm saying? That's the Israelites, man. Ain't no white boy doing all that, man. That's when they gonna be terrified when they see that. Go ahead.
As a strong
be damn shooting thing, we gonna be damn, you know what I'm saying? They gonna be shooting lasers and damn bullets, we gonna be. Yo, that's where they get that from, what the damn matrix do. They gonna be doing all that, man.
Yeah.
Right, it might hit you, it might go through you, man. You might.
Like a scratch.
You know what I'm saying?
Like a little tickle.
Yeah, it might just bounce off of you. Wow. Damn bullet gonna slow down, you gonna.
Yeah, watch
it.
That
thing,
man.
Go ahead. As a
what?
They mock your future prophecy.
Yeah, they mock your future prophecy, man. Go ahead.
As a strong people set in battle array, before their face, the people shall be much pain. All faces shall gather blackness.
Right.
They shall run like mighty men.
They shall what?
They shall run like mighty men. They shall run like mighty men.
Read.
They shall climb the wall.
We shall what?
They shall climb the wall. We're
going to climb a wall, man. He's going to be hiding, man. Go ahead, give me Jeremiah 16:16. Go ahead.
Like men of war.
Uh-huh.
And they shall march every one of his ways. And they shall not break their ranks. Neither shall one thrust another. They shall walk, everyone.
Meaning, we ain't gonna make no mistakes. Nobody gonna accidentally, everything gonna be on point. You understand what I'm saying? We not gonna get hurt. We not gonna slip and down, fall on the brother's sword by accident, trying to do too much. Go ahead.
And when they fall upon the sword, they shall not be wounded.
Wait a minute, did I just say that? Did I just say that?
Make it out.
If I fall on a sword, I'm not gonna be wounded.
Bend that sword up, man.
Right,
bend it up.
Take it out.
And keep coming, like Esau was like the white man movie.
Yeah, kind of steel.
And keep coming. Yeah, like the brother said, the damn sword might shrivel up, man, and hit the ground, man. Go ahead.
They shall run to and fro in the city. They shall run upon the wall. They shall climb up upon the houses. They shall enter in at the windows like a thief.
We going there, we looking for them.
Because
they hide from us in that day. You know what? Esau come out with the SWAT team, come out and Jake hiding under his grandma's bed. Grandma, please, grandma, don't sell me out, grandma. You know what I'm saying? Over the door, grandma. Tell him I ain't here. We don't be looking for like the police look for Jake. Go
ahead. Verse 10. The earth shall quake before them.
Right.
The earth shall quake before them.
They gonna know we coming because it's gonna feel like a damn earthquake. When we running and coming for that ass, pictures falling off the wall, they gonna say them niggas on, they coming.
Please,
you know what I'm saying? Go ahead. Yeah, no, during the time of Joshua, they were faking, man. They was faking before the men of the Lord. Right? Those days are coming back. Go ahead.
The heavens shall tremble. The sun and the moon shall be dark. And the stars shall withdraw their shine. And the Lord shall utter his voice before his army. For his camp is very great.
What the Lord say?
For his camp is very great.
I talked about the white man's military. Hey, the Lord's camp, his army. We're a camp. Right. Son of Zion, we're a camp. We got many camps all over the world. Man, we're going to come together. The Lord's going to make us, we're going to stand on our feet, a seething great army. Man.
That's right. That's right.
The Lord's camp is great, man. And we got backup, man. It's gonna be chariots, man. Angels everywhere, man. Right? And we got Yahweh Shah.
Woo! That's right. Mighty though.
You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be that. This is the greatest movie ever, man.
Quo Yashah.
The ending of this movie is gonna be so great, man. You understand? And we want y'all brothers to be a part of it. Hey, I wanna be there that day, man. Go ahead.
Right. For he is strong that executed this word. For the day of the Lord is great and very terrible. And who can abide it?
That, now bring this up.
Jeremiah chapter 16, verse 16.
Read it out.
Behold, I will send for many fishers.
Right now we fishing. The God said he gonna send for fishers. That's what we out here, we fish y'all in. We throw the bait out there and y'all kind of been here. Y'all been here for hours, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, but y'all been wanting to leave. You know what I'm saying? Brothers just stuck. You know what I'm saying? The Lord said my sheep hear my voice. Right? Y'all heard the truth today, man, and y'all addicted now. You understand? You can't leave, man. So that's our job, to be fishermen. Right? That's why we come out here. We fish y'all and we reeling y'all in.
That's right.
Bringing the elect. Just like all these brothers used to be on that side.
That's right.
That's right. You understand? Now brothers on this side. You feel me? Read.
God said the Lord, and they shall fish them.
And we're going to fish them, read.
And after will I send for many hunters.
And after we fish, it's hunting season. Right? Read.
Con. And they shall hunt them from every mountain and from every hill and out of the holes of rocks. Rocks.
You said you read about the white man, he's building underground bunkers for Doom Day?
Yep.
Man, they got swimming pools under there. They got all type of food to last for 10 years. They know what's coming. Guess what? We gonna go right to them. That's what he just read to you.
Yeah.
That's what it's gonna sound like and what it's gonna look like when we go get them.
Woo!
So we're gonna get delivered out of destruction. Esau's gonna be hiding from the destruction because he knows it's coming. And then we're gonna go and hunt them.
Right.
We're gonna be hunting season, brother. You understand? And we're not gonna need a GPS. You're not gonna have to put the GPS in and try to figure it this way. You know what I'm saying? Me and Melvin meeting up, man, we should go this way. We're not gonna try to figure out where to go. Brothers is just gonna go. The Lord gonna have us programmed. You gonna go to get some Edomites, he just gonna go. We just gonna be just going.
Break it out.
Go on, break it out. Give me a song.
Break it out, awesome.
Psalm 149.
This is the book of Micah, chapter 4, verse 13. Arise and thresh, O daughter of Zion, for I will make thine horn iron, and I will make thy hoofs brass, and thou shalt beat in pieces many people.
What the Lord say?
And thou shalt beat in pieces many people.
Right? Every other nation, they understand this, man. What happens in war, man? Legs get blown up, arms get cut off, man. People die, man. You understand? This is the only way, because when it says, let your light shine before, we can't, our light can't shine when we niggas in America. They don't respect us. So we're gonna be a light to the Gentiles. That's after all this. Then we can be a light, because they know what it is now. Now we can let our light shine. We can't be no light right now when you just a nigga. Shut up, nigga. You know what I'm saying? When you asking him for a loan. You see what I'm saying? So we gotta be exalted. You understand? Read.
Psalms 149.
Yeah. 149, yeah.
Con. Book of Psalms chapter 149 and verse 2.
Read it out.
Let Israel rejoice in him that made him. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Verse 3, let them praise his name in dance. Let them sing praises unto him with timbrel and harps. For the Lord taketh pleasure in his people.
In all people.
In his people.
Read.
He is beautified in the meek of with salvation.
Read it again.
Con. For
what,
the
what kind of Bible is this? This King James?
Bible.
I that. New Bible. Read it again. Let me see.
No, it's the
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, go ahead. No, it's cool. It's right. It's just a little different. I'm expecting to hear something else. Go ahead.
God.
You see how beautiful.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Yeah.
Verse 4. For the Most High taketh pleasure in his people.
Uh-huh.
He will beautify the meek with salvation.
The Lord going to beautify us with salvation. Go ahead. Right now, we ugly. We dirty. We filthy. You understand? Read.
Verse 5.
Brother, come here.
Let
brother.
The saints be joyful in glory.
Look at the brother. He ready. Look at the brother, man. He already fishing, man. Brother already in the spirit, man.
The word,
brother say, come get some word. Of this, man. Come get some, man. Stuff,
man.
Go ahead. Your brother's ready to go fishing.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Let the saints be joyful in glory.
The Lord said, let the saints be joyful in glory, Reed.
Let them sing aloud upon their beds.
And if y'all seen the movie, what's it called? Birth of a Nation? Y'all ever seen that? Nat Turner story? He was reading this scripture, man. He kind of moved too fast, though. You know what I'm saying? It's not for now, so just let brothers know. Brother might have that Nat Turner spirit. Brothers might go home,
yeah.
Put the damn Bible app on, land they bed, might get up and go across the hall. start jigging these mics, man. Stabbing them up. Not now. Now ain't the time. We're going to wait on the Lord.
Say right? So.
Lord said, vengeance is mine, all
right?
Your ass going to jail.
Do it now.
All right, go ahead.
Verse 6. Let the high praises of the Most High be in their mouth.
Uh-huh.
And a two-edged sword in their hand.
And a what?
And a two-edged sword in their hand.
We're going to give you a double-edged sword in
That's right.
Hand,
Woo.
That's right. A huge sword. What are we going to do with the sword? Let's see if it's to take pigeon with.
God, verse 7. To execute vengeance upon the heathens. And punishment upon the people.
We got to punish them, man. They beat the hell out of us. They fed our babies to alligators.
God.
They literally hung us on trees. They burnt. Where my brother at, man? Look at this, man. Look at this. They barbecued the teenage brother.
Right?
Burnt them alive. Or do they look sad that this happened?
No.
They're damn taking a selfie. Like they taking a picture.
Postcards too.
Look at this, man. And this is still happening today, man.
That's 6:30 over there. Yeah, so that they should commit suicide.
Read on.
Verse 8. To bind their kings with chains.
To do what?
To bind their kings with chains.
To do what?
To bind their kings with chains.
And they put chains on our children's neck, man. They put yokes of iron on our neck,
yokes
man.
Of iron.
Right. You know what this is called? Justice. God is just. So Donald Trump, he got to get a chain on his neck.
That's right.
Talking about the everyday. If these Edomites are just walking around at your job, they're going to die. They're just going to die in the nuclear fire when the bomb.
Yeah.
These talking about the people who have millions of dollars that has underground bunkers.
Bunkers, man. Come on.
Who want to go high? The rich.
Yeah.
These little regular Edomites, they ain't no good. They ain't no useful. They just going to melt away and die. This is talking about their kings and their nobles. You understand? And their families. Read on.
Con. To bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron. To execute upon them the judgment written.
Which is why we read it. We are reading what we're going to do. To execute the judgment written. Everything we've written to you, somebody got to do it.
Right.
Read.
Con. This honor have
all oh, this what?
This honor.
This is good. The Lord said it's going to be an honor to do this,
Ooh.
Man. This honor, read.
Have all his saints praise thee the Most High.
Praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah.
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 We praise the Lord for that. Right?
This is the book
of Psalms chapter 137 and verse 7.
Bring it out.
Remember, O Lord, the children of Edom.
Who the children of Edom? Right.
The white.
The Lord said, remember the children of Edom. Give me Isaiah 14:21. Go ahead.
In the day of Jerusalem, who said, raise it, even to the foundation thereof, O daughter of Babylon.
And this is how we know America is modern Babylon. When you read Revelations, it talks about the daughter of Babylon. It talks about mystery Babylon. It's not talking about the ancient Babylonians and the Kushites. Mm-hmm. Edom is the daughter of Babylon. Woo. Why? Because she's doing the same thing.
Yeah.
The word Babylon means confusion.
Yeah.
America is a land of confusion. The white man is, he teaches and he spreads confusion. Like homosexuality is confusion.
Shut up, man.
Jesus being white now all of a sudden is confusion. God loves everybody now is confusion. The new year being in January and the dead of the winter is confusion.
Right.
And the Bible says the new year is in March and spring where the flowers are blooming. And
right.
The
That's right.
That's the new year. Ain't nothing new in the dead of the middle. You're in the middle of one season.
Tell them.
Right. You understand? The damn Sabbath day being Sunday morning is confusion.
Right.
The Bible says Saturday. You understand? So that's why he's the daughter of Babylon, read.
Who ought to be destroyed.
I say he might be destroyed.
Who ought to be destroyed.
Maybe should be destroyed.
Who ought to be destroyed.
Ought to be destroyed, and he will be destroyed. All right, somebody give me Obadiah. Go ahead.
Happy shall he be.
What the Lord say?
Happy shall he be.
Now we're going to be lukewarm about it.
Happy shall he be.
We're going to be hesitant.
Happy shall he be.
We're going to be sad.
Happy shall he be.
We're going to feel sorry.
Happy shall he be.
The Lord said, happy shall we be. Read.
That rewardeth thee as thou hast served us.
God said, we're going to be happy to pay them back and do to them what they did to us. Come on.
Happy shall he be that taketh and dasheth thy little ones against the stones.
Brother, do you want to take little white babies and crack their skulls against the stone?
That sounds crazy. So I'll teach y'all.
Okay, he got it. You want to do that, brother? Can you handle that? Are you really ready for that? Can you handle that?
Oh, wow.
That's nasty. Brother, didn't they feed our babies to alligators, man? Didn't they cut our mother's stomach open and take the babies out, man? They didn't wait till she had the baby. They was taking babies out of their stomach. They put cats in our mother's stomach, specifically Northern Kingdom, sewed the stomach back up with the cats in the stomach and let them scratch the inside out. But you know that's a horrible way to die? That's justice. The Lord said the saints gonna be happy. Maybe y'all not saying. No, I like what you said, though. You said in that day, right?
Yeah.
You understand?
That day, I'm
going to
have to do it.
That's right.
That's
right. It's not for us to do now. Yeah. It's not for you to go and look. This is prophecy. All right? We know these things are going to happen. This is what we look forward to. Read on.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 58 and verse 10.
I don't want to be around no brother that, well, why would you do I can't be around brothers like that, man. I don't be around the men of the Lord, man.
Right.
That want what God want, man.
Right.
Right, that's about justice, man. Right? Some people say that, they say I'm about justice, especially you ask white people. They're about justice until it come to them, it happening to them. If you ask white man, how did the white people get America? Yeah, I mean, you know, we fought, we went to war. No, you didn't. It wasn't no even, it wasn't no one-on-one battle where the Native American Indians know and the Hispanics knew they were about to go to war and they prepared. No, you snuck in here. They showed you love and kindness and you stabbed them in the back.
Right.
And they took our daughters. They was raping our daughters, man. They was impregnating our daughters, man. They were raping our men. Go ahead.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 58 and verse 10.
Bring it out.
The righteous shall rejoice when he seeth the vengeance.
When we see the vengeance, we're going to rejoice in that day. Right? Because see, some of us, we different, man. Some of us, we love our people. Some of us sit and cry and weep today for our foreparents and our foremothers, man, and what they went through. We don't forget about that, man. Some of our people selfish, saying, oh, that was then. You understand? Go ahead.
He shall wash his feet in the
imagine you had a son or a daughter that was murdered. Right? Is there any amount of time they go by where you say, well, it's over, that was back then? Will you give up on justice? Will you say, well, you know, just let them get away? They found the man that did that to your child. And you say, it's been a long time. God said forgive. Give me Isaiah 27:11. No, God said forgive your neighbor, forgive right. your brother. We don't have a problem forgiving white people another neighbor. We have a problem forgiving one another. We have a problem loving each other. We don't got no problem loving them. Niggas fall out the bed loving the white man. You ain't gotta tell a nigga to love white people. He gonna do it automatically. I'm asking a question though. If you saw and the person who murdered your child, would you want justice? Would you say it's been 5 years, let him go? Is there any amount of time where you just let it go?
No.
So why don't these people get justice? Why they suffering gotta be in vain then? Read.
He shall wash his feet in the blood of the wicked.
Man, you know what type of time you gotta be on, man?
Wash his feet.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. To dance in the blood of the wicked while you down, man, busting their kids' head open, man. We're gonna have a party in their blood. Our garments is gonna get, even the Lord, give me Isaiah 63. Real quick, Isaiah 63 and 1. Show you the right, the Messiah, who everybody so called said ain't waiting to come save.
Yeah.
Let's see what he's gonna do.
Yeah.
The book of Isaiah chapter 63 verse 1.
Bring it out.
No. Who is this that coming from Edom?
Coming from where?
Coming from Edom.
Edom is the people, not literally the place Edom, but it's talking about the people. That's right. This brother on fire. Go ahead.
Con. With dyed garments.
With what?
With dyed garments.
How is Christ's garment dyed when he's going to have on an all-white garment?
Right.
Read.
Con, from Bozrah.
Bozrah is the capital of Edom. Meaning he's going to the chiefest Edomites. He's got these little regular Edomites. He's going to the chiefest Edomites. Read.
Con, this that is glorious in his apparel, traveling in the greatness of his strength. I that speak it in righteous, mighty to save.
What is he?
Mighty to save.
Who's the Savior? Talking about Christ. This is the prophecy. Mighty to save, read.
Con. Wherefore art thou red in thine apparel?
So Isaiah saw the vision of what's going to happen in the last days when the Lord come back. He asking the Lord, what's going on with your garment? It probably look crazy too. Right. I say, why your garment all red like that? Read.
God, and thy garment like him that treadeth the wine fat.
Why your clothes look like you've been squashing in the wine press and squashing grapes? Like that little kid you leave in the kitchen with the spaghetti, with the thing open on the thing, and you come back in there, he got spaghetti all on his face. You know what I'm saying? Read.
God, verse 3. I have tread the wine press alone, and of the people, there was none with me, for I will tread them down in mine anger.
You will what?
I will tread them down in my anger.
Read.
And trample them in my fury.
And do what?
And trample them in my fury.
Read.
And their blood shall be con. And their blood shall sprinkle upon my garment, and I will stain all my remnant.
You say, I'm gonna get down and dirty. It's about to get nasty out here, man. See, yeah, I wish I was going to kill certain people. You got a hit list. We're going to get some. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Everybody got to go get some. But yeah, I wish I had a hit list. You understand? There's certain people he got to get up with them, man. That's why we tell people, watch your mouth, man. People come up saying stuff. You know what I'm saying? A lot of these Edomites, man. A lot of these Edomites from the past. And he say every, give me Revelation 1 and, what was that, 7? Yeah, hold that.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 7. Behold, he coming with clouds.
He what?
He coming with clouds.
These clouds are chariots. Is it talking about the Lord coming on a rain cloud?
No.
Let's prove that. Give me Psalms 103 and 104 and 3. Get that real quick and come back to that. We got to show y'all This is how you understand the Bible, precept upon precept. Because the Lord not coming back on a rain cloud. All right, the Bible is written like this, so our oppressor who stole our book couldn't really understand it. Because if he could understand it, we wouldn't have it until he would burn it up. So the white man don't really understand the Bible. Only the Israelites can teach the Bible. You understand? So this is how we understand this. You got it?
Who laid the... Psalms chapter 104, verse 3. Who laid the beams of his chambers in the water, who maketh his clouds a chariot, his chariot.
Who do what?
Who maketh the clouds his chariot.
Who maketh the clouds his chariot. So this cloud is talking about a huge UFO, a spaceship. All right? Yeah. We roll on spaceships, bro. You understand? The white man, he ride cars that you need gas in it. They'll run out of gas. You need an oil change. You got to change the tires on it. You understand? We drive chariots, man. We different, man. We kind of just get there. We kind of just pop up on you. You understand? We're not going to have to catch the train drive to the beach. I tell Elder Linda, hey, let's go to the beach, take our family to the beach. We just going to pop up at the beach, right? You understand? Go ahead. Keep going.
Stop.
Nah, that's it on that. Oh, finish that.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 7.
Bring it out.
Behold, he coming with clouds, and every eye shall see him.
And what?
And every eye shall see him.
And what?
And every eye shall see him.
That's how big this chariot gonna be. When the Lord come back, everybody go, you gonna see him. Read.
And they also which pierced him.
Wait a minute, and what?
And they also which pierced him.
Wait a minute, so who pierced him? Those Romans, right, that pierced him when he was on that cross? That means they're going to be back here again. So those Edomites are here somewhere. So those that pierced him and put him up on that cross, literally, even though we gave him up due to prophecy, right, they're going to see him. So the Lord has a hit list. You think he ain't going to get up with them, man? You think he ain't coming back through, man? Go back over here. Yeah.
Book of Isaiah, chapter 63, verse 4.
Bring it out.
For the day of vengeance is in mine heart.
Wait a minute. The day of vengeance. Where is the Lord right now? Where is Christ right now? Right, where?
Right.
Yeah, where is he right now?
He's in heaven.
Where?
Where?
Yeah. He's in heaven. Where at in heaven?
Where at in
what
heaven?
What are you doing right now? Yeah.
Look.
Sitting on the throne, he's on the right hand of his father. Right? And you know what he's been doing this whole time? Meditating and thinking about the day of vengeance. Read it again.
God, Isaiah chapter 63, verse 4. For the day of vengeance is in mine heart.
It's on the Lord's mind. He can't wait. He's thinking about it. He's waiting on y'all. When these niggas gonna repent? We need y'all to repent, man. All right, the Lord not waiting on us. I mean, we not waiting on the Lord. The Lord waiting on us to repent. We need 144,000. All right? We need brothers to repent, come into this truth, and change our ways. Don't just listen to us all goddamn day today, and then tomorrow go back and just go through one end out the other, y'all forget everything. Don't be those brothers. Yeah. Next thing you go to the ball tomorrow, you see an Edomite, you forget everything. Right? Because she going to roll right up on you, too, out of nowhere. She going to smell your neck. I'll pray. Go ahead.
And the year of my redeem is come.
And what?
And the year of my redeem is come.
That's right. That's it. Man. Yeah.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 14, verse 21.
Look it out.
Prepare slaughter for his children.
The Lord said prepare slaughter for the children of the slave master. Because they think they got away with it, man. Somebody got to answer. Somebody got to pick up the towel. So the Lord said we got to prepare slaughter. How do we prepare slaughter for them? How do we do it? By repenting. Keeping the commandments.
Right.
Loving your brother as yourself. Right? Spreading the gospel, right? Prophesying. Teaching his word. Fasting and praying. That's how we prepare slaughter for them.
Go ahead.
Con. For the iniquity of their fathers.
They got to pay for the iniquities of their forefathers. They got to pay for what their fathers did. Read.
Con.
And it's not them actually paying for the sins of their forefathers, because they are their forefathers. Right? That's why the Lord has a certain season and a chosen generation that had to come back in the earth.
Right.
These are the same people that had to be back here again.
Right.
Right? Just like Jacob and Jacob had to, Abel has to be the one to kill Cain. You understand? Read that.
Come. That they do not rise, nor possess the land, nor fill the face of the earth with cities.
They're never going to fill the face of the earth with cities again. When a white man is taken out of power, that's it, man. You understand? Jump up to verse 1. Jump up to verse 1.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 1.
Bring it out.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob.
He's going to have mercy on everybody.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob.
Who's the Lord going to have mercy on? Jacob. Who is Jacob? Right. That's right. We the seed of Jacob. Jacob's name was changed to Israel. He had 12 sons. It makes up the 12 tribes of Israel. All right? So the Lord's going to have mercy on Jacob. Go ahead.
And will yet choose Israel.
And do what?
And will yet choose Israel.
At the end of the day, he's always going to choose Israel. Why? It's already written. He already made a promise to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. All right? The Lord is not going to go back on this promise just because white people came into power and they don't like it and they want to tell you something different.
Right.
Well, the Lord, well, we actually the people.
Right.
Y'all not, and y'all lucky that y'all can come in and get grafted in. That's right. Basically what they said.
Yeah.
Y'all really the Gentile. That's literally
madness,
how it went.
Madness.
You know what I'm saying? Well, really, God did away with the Israelites because they sinned, right? And he came to the Gentiles, all right, which is y'all, right? Black people. Yeah, that's what they say. No, it was already written. That's why they don't want you in the Old Testament. This is a prophecy. This is talking about the end time. So at the end of the day, God is going to choose Israel, the Israelites. Read.
And set them in their own land.
I thought they already in the land.
And set them in their own land.
Why does Christ got to come and take us back to our land if in 1948, so-called Jewish was put back in Israel? They ain't supposed to see that. See, they done messed. These white people so dumb, right? They ain't supposed to be in the land. How you already back in the land? The Lord is going to put us back in the land. We right where we're supposed to be. In captivity, under the hands of our oppressors.
Strangers shall be joined with them.
And the strangers are going to be joined with us, the other nations. Come on.
And they shall cleave to the house of Jacob.
Uh-huh.
And the people shall take them and bring them to their place.
The Lord said we're going to take them and bring them to our kingdom. Right, read.
And the house of
Israel. And that's what's going, when we go, remember we was reading about climbing over mountains and going in and grabbing them up and putting fetters of iron and chains on their neck? That's what we're going to get them and we're going to bring them to our kingdom. Then they put us on the bottom of slave ships, chain us up and bring us to America. Huh? And set us up on plantation and had sales, give me Joel 3, and was selling us from plantation to plantation. Come on.
And the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of
the... Wait a minute. The house of Israel going what?
Shall possess them in the land of the Lord.
The land of the Lord is the kingdom of heaven. So somebody's going to be a possession. They're going to be our possession in the kingdom of heaven. Read.
For
servants
and handmaids.
Were we their servants and handmaids?
Yeah.
Right. This is justice. It's called trading places. The Lord about to flip this thing on me. Read.
God, and they shall take them captives.
And they shall take them captive. Read.
Whose captives they were.
They got to go into slavery because they put us in slavery.
Come.
That's just what's going to happen. Read.
God, and they shall rule over their oppressors.
We're going to rule with our oppressors.
And they shall rule over their oppressors.
We're going to rule over our oppressors.
That's right.
He rules over us. A nigga just want to rule with him now. He don't care that he ruled with him and destroyed your whole family and your whole life. Took everything from you. He just want to be, I just want the white man just to help me out and I'll forgive you. No. We want what God wants.
That's right.
Go ahead. Keep going. It's a little more.
God. Verse 3. And it shall come to pass.
And it shall come to pass. It ain't happened yet.
That's why we out here. All right, we gotta get y'all brothers right and prepare y'all for this. We want y'all to see this day.
Yeah.
Cause 2/3 of our people gonna miss out on this.
Right. Right.
They gonna be a nigga their whole life and then go in the lake of fire.
That's right.
That's a horrible life. When you have an opportunity to get everything back in blood. We don't want reparations. You understand? You can't pay me for the blood and the life of my family.
Ain't no amount of money.
The white man's money is about to dissipate anyway. You don't have nothing else. The money is about to be deleted anyway. You can't pay me. I wouldn't be surprised if a white man give niggas $1 billion and then a reparation the day before the dollar crash.
He gonna give niggas
reparations the 2 hours before the dollar crash.
Jake gonna still try to spend it.
Go ahead.
God. And it shall come to pass in the day that the Lord shall give thee rest.
Shall what?
Shall give thee rest.
Shall what?
Shall give thee rest.
All right, brother, work. Keep working hard. You understand? In righteousness. The Lord gonna give you rest. Right now is not our, this place is not our rest. That's Micah 2 and 10. This place, America's not our rest. It's not for us to get comfortable and rest. Right? It's for us to endure. Our rest is coming. Come on.
Con, from thy sorrow and from thy fear and from thy heart, the hard bondage wherein thou was made to serve.
But when we was made to serve. You understand? Bring this up.
This is the book of Joel, chapter 3. And I'm going to start at verse 2. And I will gather all nations, and I will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat.
So the Lord, these are all end time prophecy readings, y'all. The Lord is going to gather all nations. That's what this last war, Armageddon, is about.
Right.
Why do you think North Korea, right, China, Russia, all these nations have nuclear firepower? It used to be a time where only America had it. They were called third world countries. Now third world countries like North Korea got damn nuclear missiles. Why does everybody have nuclear missiles?
Intimidation.
Give me that in Isaiah 24:54. Let's read this real quick. And 16?
54 and 16.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 54 and verse 16. Now, behold, I have created the smith.
What is a smith? Smith is somebody who makes weapons.
Right.
So the Lord, who created the smith? Did the white man create the nuclear side? No, he didn't. He did. But the Lord did. Let me show you something. Give me Proverbs 21 and 1.
Yeah.
Give me Daniel chapter 4 and verse 17.
I got Daniel 4:17.
Yeah, 21 and 1, I believe.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 21, from the top. The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord.
God,
the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord.
What the Lord say?
The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord.
The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord.
Right.
Didn't the Lord harden Pharaoh's heart?
Yeah.
When Pharaoh decided he wanted to let the children of Israel go because the Lord was plaguing him, what changed his mind? God controlled his mind.
Yeah.
Right.
God told Moses, I'm a harden Pharaoh's heart. Because guess what? I got more plagues.
Yeah.
I'm not done yet. I don't want him to let y'all go yet. I'm not finished. So he sent a spirit, okay, on Pharaoh, and Pharaoh just woke up and said, I'm not letting these go. You understand?
Hell no.
God controls. You understand? Go ahead. Keep going.
As the rivers of water, he turneth it whithersoever he will.
God does what he wants, my man. You see what I'm saying? The Lord said we were going to slavery on ships, right? We read that in the Bible, Deuteronomy 28:68. Right? The Lord said, you shall serve your enemies in one of all things.
Right.
The so-called white man is just a puppet. The Lord is using him.
Yeah.
The Lord controls him.
Right.
Give me Proverbs 16:4.
Right.
The Lord made him to be the wicked.
Bring it on.
Right. Bring it on. Give me Daniel first.
Come on.
Daniel 4:17.
Daniel chapter 4, verse 17.
Bring it up.
This matter is by the decree of the watchers and the demand by the words of the Holy One, to the intent that the living may know that the Most
High. That the living may know. This is something we got to know. This is mystery. This is a secret. All right? That the average person don't know. See, man thinks they got free will. Think he can kind of do what he wanted. Think he making his own decision. People don't know that you don't have free will. If you had free will, you wouldn't be here today.
Yeah.
You understand? If you had free will, you wouldn't have forgot your damn wallet the other day.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You would have the job that you want. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
You wouldn't have made the mistakes that you made if it was up to you. But it's not in man to walk it to direct the steps, but of God. Read that.
Khan, that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men.
That God ruleth in the kingdom of men.
Right.
And giveth it to whosoever he will.
And do what?
And giveth it to whosoever he will.
So if the Lord said it's time for the white man to rule, guess what? How it plays out is up to the Lord.
Right.
When it was time for the Greeks to come into power, when you read the book of Daniel, the Lord told them before it happened.
Right.
He told them how these things were going to play out. Kid. You see what I'm saying? That's how we're able to come out here, go through the Bible, and show you what's going on now. Because the Lord already got it written.
That's right.
It's already recorded.
Right.
Give me 2 and 17. Yeah.
And set it up over it the base of men.
Like the white man. He's the weakest and the basest of all creatures. But yet God put him on top. You understand? That's why it's a curse. Because we've been ruled over by somebody that we're better and stronger than.
Right.
That's God showing us his power.
Yeah.
You understand? Go ahead. 2 and 17.
Come on. It's the book of Daniel, chapter 2, verse 17.
Bring it up.
Then Daniel went into his house and made the thing known to Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, his companion.
What did he say? Bring it out.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 16 and verse 4.
Bring it out.
The Lord hath made all things for himself, yea, even the wicked for the day of evil.
Right.
Read again, slide.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 16 and verse 4.
Bring it out.
The Lord hath made all things for himself.
The Lord made everything for himself, right?
Yeah.
He's the creator.
Right.
Read.
Yea. Even the wicked for the day of evil.
Even the wicked were created for a specific day of evil. That's the only reason they were made.
Yeah.
Right? Now go back to Isaiah 54.
Bring it on.
This is the book of Isaiah.
So the Lord used the white man to make these nuclear missiles, but he's the one that put it in his mind to do it.
Right. God.
We read about nuclear missiles all over the scripture before they were ever created.
You know? Right.
How do you think we know about the end time?
Right.
Give me Isaiah 34. Give me Isaiah 34. Read that.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 54, verse 16.
Bring it out.
Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals
now,
in the fire.
Wait a minute. This is something. This is not talking about a bang bang a gun.
Yeah.
It's not talking about a bow and arrow or a sword.
Mm.
All right. The smith that maketh weapons.
The metallurgist.
That bloweth the coal. If you know anything about how nuclear missiles are made, right? And keep going.
That bloweth the coals in the fire.
In the what?
In the fire.
In the fire. Did the Lord say, behold, the Lord come with fire? What you think the lake of fire is? People think the lake of fire is some damn pool of fire underground. No, America, when John the Revelator described the lake of fire, he looked down after going up in the chariot. Above the firmament, he looked down and he described it because America looked like a lake of fire, like
That's
a pool of fire.
That's right.
Right? Talks about the mushroom clouds. Right? Where do mushroom clouds come from? Nuclear missiles.
Right.
We're going to show you that.
And that bringeth forth an instrument for his work.
Hey, what?
And bringeth forth an instrument for his work.
Bringeth forth an instrument for his work.
His
nuclear missiles. These missiles were designed to wipe out civilizations, to kill multitudes of people, to destroy the entire America. That's why, give me Zechariah chapter
And I have created the waster.
The what?
And I have created the waster.
The waster. What is the waster? Intercontinental ballistic missiles.
Right.
God said he created the waster. Right? He used a white man to do it. So he gets the credit, but really it's God doing it. That's the mystery. Come on.
To destroy.
To what?
To destroy.
To destroy. Give me Zechariah 14:12.
Isaiah chapter 34 from the top. Come near, ye nations, to hear, and hearken, ye people. Let the earth hear, and all that is therein, the world and all things that come forth of it. For the indignation of the Lord is...
Indignation is strong anger. The indignation of the Lord, go ahead.
Is upon all nations.
Is what?
Is upon all nations.
The indignation and the anger of the Lord is upon all these nations. Read.
And his fury upon all the armies.
Upon what?
Upon all their armies.
Upon all their armies. All their armies are being set up in a line. All the nations that's going to come together are coming together. All the nations that has nuclear might are getting there. They're doing their test runs. They're preparing for war. God is doing this. He already had it written before they knew it.
That's right.
God is controlling. He rules in the kingdom of men. We just read that. Go ahead.
Con. Upon all nations, his fury is upon their army. He had utterly destroyed them. He had delivered them to slaughter.
He did what?
He had delivered them to the slaughter.
Read.
Verse 3. Their slain also shall cast out, and their stink shall come up out of their carcasses, and the mountains shall be melted.
Shall what?
Shall be melted.
Shall be what?
Shall be melted.
What can melt mountains? What can melt mountains, man?
Lava.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Con. With their blood. Verse 4. And all the host of heaven.
And all the host of heaven. That word host means army. Read.
Shall be dissolved.
Shall what?
Shall be dissolved.
Shall be dissolved. Read. And go look up tonight when you go home. Go look up those nuclear, if it was to happen, those simulations. All right? It's going to make more sense. Read.
Con. And the heaven shall roll together.
And the heaven shall roll together. Read.
As a scroll.
As a what?
As a scroll.
As a scroll. Pull up a mushroom cloud. You know what a scroll look like, right? Pull up a mushroom cloud. So the Lord has already written, the prophet's already seen it. What is going to look like? Ooh, that's a good one. Show the brothers that. That's the heavens. And the heavens is talking about the sky.
Mushroom, yeah.
Rolling together as a scroll. That's a mushroom cloud. You see that? Go ahead.
Con.
All nations have the ability to have this. Some have greater power than the other, but the point is, when all these nations come together to fight each other, they're gonna let these missiles off. Read.
Con. And all their hosts shall fall down as leaf falleth from the vine.
Uh-huh.
And as the fallen fig from the fig tree.
Yep.
Verse 5. For my sword is bathed in heaven.
What the Lord say?
For my sword is bathed in heaven.
The Lord's sword is bathed in heaven. Read. Right. That's all that blood. Read.
Right. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea.
Wait a minute. It's going to come down on America.
Right. That's right.
Idumea is a Greek word for Edom. Read. America's the top kingdom. Esau's kingdom is right here in America. Everybody comes, so it's a great melting pot.
Right.
Read.
Con. And upon the people of my curse to judgment.
And the people of his curse is who? Us. Two-thirds of our people that don't repent, they're going to get the same judgment. You understand? Read.
Verse 6. The sword of the Most High is filled with blood. It is made fatness and with blood of lamb and goat and with blood of the kidney of rams, for the Lord had a sacrifice in Bozrah.
The Lord said he got to sacrifice in bars. You know when we used to make sacrifices? We had to slaughter animals.
Right.
That's right.
You know, we read earlier, the Lord said prepare slaughter for his children. Mm-hmm. The Lord got to sacrifice in bars. We preparing the sacrifice for these goddamn white people that y'all love, man.
Right.
Read.
God. And a great slaughter in the land of Idumea.
And a great slaughter in America, man.
Yeah. Right.
And a great slaughter in America, man. Right? But you want to be saved out of here. That's what it means. That's what it's talking about.
Right.
It's not talking about, oh, Jesus. No. Give me Revelation 18 and 4 real quick. You got Zechariah? Revelation 18 and 4.
Book of Revelation, chapter 18, verse 4.
Bring it out.
And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people.
What did the Lord say?
Come out of her, my people.
Who is God's people? Who's the her that he's asking us to come out of? America. He's talking about her philosophy. He's not talking about leave here, because God can save you out of here. He's talking about her philosophies, her religion, yeah, her politics, her homosexuality. Right. Separate from this place. Come back to your heritage and inspire. Come out of her, my people. You understand?
Right.
Read.
God, that ye be not partakers of her sins.
That you don't partake in her sins. America promotes sin.
Right.
And wickedness.
Right.
And homosexuality and all manner of evil.
Right.
America is the most evilest kingdom ever. Read.
Right.
God, and that ye receive not of her plagues.
And that you don't receive of her plagues. God sent plagues on ancient Egypt. He's going to do the same thing to modern Egypt, which is America. He's going to send plagues.
What's
the plague? Let's see what the plague is.
This is the book of Zechariah, chapter 14 and verse 12.
Bring it out.
And this shall be the plague.
This shall be the plague. Read.
Wherewith the Lord will smite all the people that have fought against Jerusalem.
All the people that have fought against Jerusalem, the Israelites. Jerusalem is our home.
That's right.
Read.
Okay. Read.
Their flesh.
Their what?
Their flesh.
Their flesh. This is the, God is saying, look, I am going to send plagues on America.
Right.
My people are in America. Y'all need to repent and come out of her. Get your mind out of that place and repent.
Right.
Because I'm going to send my son and he's going to bring salvation and deliverance.
Right.
You're going to be beamed up into the chariots before the destruction comes.
Come.
If you don't, you're going to be partakers of the plague.
Right. Their flesh.
Their what?
Their flesh.
Your flesh, Reed.
Shall consume away while they stand upon their feet.
While they what?
While they stand upon their feet.
Reed.
And their eyes shall consume away in their hole. And their tongue shall consume away in their mouth.
Right.
And it shall come to pass in that day that a great tumult from the Lord shall be among them. And they shall lay hold every one on the hand of his neighbor. And his hand shall rise up against the hand of his neighbor.
And that's going into the wars and the race wars. But the point is, the plague is you get melted by that thermonuclear fire.
Yeah.
While you standing on your feet, you just melt. And it's going to be painful. You're going to suffer in that fire. You understand? It's not going to be a quick, easy death.
Yeah.
You're going to suffer. It's going to be very painful. You understand? Give me Malachi 4:1.
It's the book of Malachi. Chapter 4 from the top.
Bring it out.
And behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven.
The Lord said a day is coming, it's gonna feel like you're literally in the oven. Go ahead.
And all the proud.
And what?
And all the proud.
All the prideful and the proud, read.
Yea, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble.
Shall what?
Shall be stubble.
Keep going.
And the day that cometh shall burn them up.
Shall what?
Shall burn them up.
Read.
Saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch.
See that fire, man. Give me 2 Peter chapter 3 and verse 9. Give me verse 10. Hold on.
This is the book of 2 Peter, chapter 3 and verse 9. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise.
What promise? We've been reading the promise. The Lord is not slack. What they say? They say, y'all been saying it. Even since I was young, my grandma and them been talking about the Lord coming back. You understand? But no, they had it wrong. The Lord told you how it's supposed to play out. Give me Matthew 24 and 14.
Stay right there. We're Matthew 24:14. Now it's go time. I'm going to show you how you know you really living in the last days. Grandma, Big Mama, them didn't know about hydrogen nuclear missiles, man. You understand? They didn't know about the brick and NATO. You understand it? World War III. They didn't know that. Read that.
It's the book of Matthew chapter 24, verse 14.
Bring it out!
And this gospel of the kingdom shall preach in all the world for a witness unto the nation.
Hold on, read that again. And this what?
And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world.
Shall be what?
Shall be preached in all the world.
So the gospel of Christianity has been taught everywhere. It wasn't talking about Christianity. It's talking about what we teaching, the truth, that we the Israelites, we God's
church.
Salvation is for us. That wasn't being taught. My great grandma didn't know about, she know about no Israelite. You understand? So this gospel shall be taught throughout all the world. Read.
For a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come.
And then the end is going to come.
Right.
So
right.
Now the truth is out. Now you know you're living in the end time. Grandma and them didn't have the truth. They still thought Jesus was white.
Right.
That's right.
And just around the corner.
So the Lord said he's not slack concerning these prophecies or any of promise that he made unto Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob in that seed. Go ahead.
And some men count slackness, but is long suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance.
So the Lord is long suffering, right? Everybody needs an opportunity to hear this word so they have an opportunity to repent. It's not going to be no excuse, right? Nobody's going to be able to say they didn't know.
Right.
Right? Whether you just way over there walking by and just ignore us, you got brothers on the street all over the world.
Right.
Social media, YouTube, the truth is out. It's everywhere. You understand? Go ahead.
Verse 10, but the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night.
No, the Lord going to stick his hand out to heaven and say, hey, y'all, about to go down. Y'all ready?
But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night.
If a thief coming to rob your house, brother, he going to ring the doorbell. He going to sneak in.
Right.
That's why the Lord said, watch and pray.
Right.
You want to be that brother that's looking out the window when the thief pull up.
Right.
Right.
You know, in the hood, they always got the nose, and neighbor. I always got that one blind broke right there.
Crown.
They always out the window watching their neighbor. Yeah. That's how you want to be. You want to be watching the signs of the prophets.
Right.
You want to be paying attention, praying, looking for the signs that he gave you. Because some of us are going to be ready and prepared because we watching the times that we in.
That's right.
We're not watching basketball all day.
Right.
And playing video games. We watching what's going on with Russia.
Right.
And China. Why? Because it ties up the prophets. That let us know where we at.
Right.
Right? We watching how many brothers are coming into this truth.
Right.
You understand? Go ahead.
In the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise.
We just read about the heavens passing away with a great noise. Read.
In the elements.
In the what?
In the elements.
The elements, read.
Shall melt with fervent heat.
What can melt the elements with fervent heat? Nuclear missiles. Where everything just... You're going to melt. Talking about that nuclear missile. World War III. Armageddon. Let's read that. You can drop that. Bring this up. 11 and 14. Revelation 11 and 14. Go back to Joel.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 11 and verse 14.
Bring it out.
The second woe is past. And behold.
What's the second woe?
World War II.
World War II. Right? So prophecy.
Yeah.
The second war, we had World War I, they had World War II. There's one more World War.
Read.
World War III. You understand? Read.
And behold, the third woe cometh quickly.
That's right!
Come quick.
Come!
Nobody's paying attention. You got all these nations with nuclear missiles threatening each other.
Come!
Doing practice runs. Israel just went to war last night with us, with the Syrians. That's big. That's major when it comes to prophecy. The stage is set. It can happen at any moment. Go ahead.
And the seventh angel sounded in there.
That's it on that. Go back to Joel now.
This is the book of Joel, chapter 3 and verse 2.
Yeah.
I will also gather all nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat.
Now this is the prophecy that it's talking about. This is World War III. He's bringing all nations. The valley of Jehoshaphat is talking about, that means in the Hebrew, God, Yahweh's decision. God's judgment. All right? All nations are going to be brought down to God's judgment. Go ahead. Because God already judged us. We've been dealing with God's judgment this whole time.
Right.
Being in America. They ain't got judgment yet.
Right.
The Lord said their sins have to reach into the heavens.
Right.
Then he's going to come and get them.
Yeah.
You understand? Read.
And will plead with them there for my people.
Wait a minute. All these nations are going to war, and God is going to judge them for you. That's what the war is about. Two-thirds of our people are going to get caught up in it.
Right.
Because they still reject God.
That's right.
Even in spite of Yahushua dying for them.
That's right.
They're going to be casted out as heathen. Read.
And for my heritage Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations and parted my land.
In various trades. And when did they part God's land?
Suez Canal.
When they cut off Israel from Africa and created the Suez Canal. You understand? Go ahead.
Verse 3. And they have cast lots for my people.
And they have what?
And they have cast lots for my people.
They cast lots for us. Didn't they do that?
Read. And have given a boy for an harlot.
This is the transatlantic slave trade right here in the Bible.
Read.
That's literally the transatlantic slave trade written before it happened. Read.
And sold a girl for wine.
And sold a girl for wine. This is what the slave trade was about. Read.
That they might drink. Yay. And what have ye to do with me? Oh, Tyre and Zidon.
Tyre and Zidon are the Hamites, Africans. We not Africans. Africans traded us and did business with the so-called white men.
That's right!
And on the coast of Palestine, will ye render me a recompense?
Uh-huh.
And if ye recompense me swiftly and speedily, will I return your recompense upon your own head?
Tell them!
The Most High talking smack.
Right!
That's what we get it from. That's what we talk like that. And the Lord talking smack, man. Go ahead.
Because ye have taken my silver and my gold and have carried away into your temples my goodly pleasant things.
Go ahead.
The children also of Judah.
The children of Judah.
Come!
The Jews, Judah, Benjamin, and Levi.
That's right.
Right?
Come!
And the children of Jerusalem.
And the children of Jerusalem, the northern kingdom.
Right? Come! Now he sold unto the Grecians.
They sold us to the white man.
White
man!
Black people didn't sell. We didn't sell ourselves. Another dark-skinned people sold God's chosen people.
That ye might remove them far from their border.
That's why we ended it. That's why we're in the land of the north. We moved far from our home.
That's right.
We're on the other side of the world. It was written. We're supposed to be here. Okay? Come on. Doesn't that make the story so much better? You understand?
Verse 7. Behold, I will raise them out of the place whether ye have sold them.
The Lord said, guess what? Lord talking this smack. You understand? He said, look, I'm going to raise them up where you took them to. No matter what you do, I'm going to raise them up. Just like you brothers being raised up right now. You understand? Knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, that's the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit has come upon you, brothers. Your understanding has been opened up. You understand? You've already acknowledged what sin is and that you're willing to keep the commandment. That's the law being sealed in your mind. Right? That's Isaiah 8 and 16.
And will return your recompense upon your own head.
Uh-huh.
And I will sell your sons.
I will what?
And I will sell your sons.
God said, he told a white man and the African, I'm going to sell your sons. Didn't they sell our sons?
And your daughters into the hand of the children of Judah.
Wait a minute. It's going to be another slave trade. God said, since they sold us, he going to sell their sons and daughters into the hands of the children of Judah.
Read. And they shall sell them to the Sabians.
And we're going to sell them to other Israelites. Go ahead.
To a people far off.
Uh-huh.
For the Lord has spoken it.
For what?
For the Lord has spoken it.
No, we're a hate group and the Israelites just making it up.
For the Lord has spoken it.
Like Brother Jonathan said.
For the Lord has spoken it. This among the Gentiles.
Uh-huh.
Prepare war.
Do what?
Prepare war.
You know what I'm saying?
Prepare war.
Prepare love.
Prepare war.
Prepare war.
Right.
Prepare war, man. Give me Jeremiah 28 and 8. Go ahead.
Wake up, the mighty men.
Do what?
Wake up, the mighty men.
Wake up, the mighty men. Y'all the mighty men.
Right.
That's been sleep in sleeper cells all this time. But the white man been drugging us up, man. Yeah. Feeding us lies and his philosophies, man. Yeah.
Come on.
You understand his fake-ass democracy.
Right.
The Lord said, "Greed, right. Wake up the mighty man.
That's Start right.
up their spirit. Greed.
Let all the men of war draw near.
Let all the men of war draw near. It's go time.
Come.
Go ahead.
Let them come up. Beat your plowshares into swords.
Uh-huh.
And your pruning hooks into spears.
Right.
Let the weak say, I am strong.
I'm gonna say,
let the weak say, I am strong.
The Lord told all these nations, say, look, man, North Korea, all these third world countries that used to be weak and scared of America, now they standing up saying, I'm strong. Look what I got.
Oh, fight.
Every day you look up, another nation showing their nuclear might, their nuclear power. Look what I got. Everybody showing off. You understand? Read.
Verse 11. Assemble yourselves and come. Oh, ye heathen.
Oh, what?
Oh, ye heathen.
All the heathen. The Lord said, come on. All right, you done did everything I done said. All y'all got y'all missiles ready? Yep. You ready? Let them destroy each other.
Ah,
you understand?
Destroy each other. Read.
And gather yourselves together round about. Thither, cause thy mighty ones to come down, O Lord. Let the heathen be wakened and come up to the valley of Jehoshaphat.
Guys, judge me. Read.
Right.
For there will I sit to judge all the heathen.
The Lord said he's going to judge all these nations now. Read.
Round about, put ye in the sickle, for the harvest is ripe.
What?
Put ye in the sickle, for the harvest is ripe.
Read.
Come get you down, for the press is full, the fats overflow, for their wickedness is great. Multitudes. Multitudes in the valley of decision.
Uh-huh.
For the day of the Lord is near.
What the Lord say?
For the day of the Lord is near.
What the Lord say?
For the day of the Lord is near.
Read.
In the valley of decision, the sun and the moon shall be dark, darkened, and the stars shall withdraw their shining.
And it's this sun and this moon that's going to be, it's not literally talking about it's going to be dark and the sun and the moon. No, it's talking about the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of these damn devils and these heathens.
That's right.
They're going to be confounded. You understand? That's why we filling up our glasses and our oil.
Right.
You understand? Knowledge, wisdom, and understanding is with us. Give me Isaiah 33 and 4. What I had you get?
33 and 6.
Yeah, bring this up. Read that real quick.
God, Jeremiah chapter 28, verse 8.
Look it up.
The prophets that had been before me and before thee of old prophesied both against many countries and against great kingdoms of war.
Of what?
Of war.
Of what?
Of war.
Of war. War is a part of this. You understand?
Right.
If you want your kingdom back, you gotta fight. You gotta go to war. Give me Daniel chapter 7 and 18. Go ahead.
God, and of evil and of pestilence.
Uh-huh.
The prophets which prophesied of peace, when the word of the prophet shall come to pass, then shall the prophet be known that the Most High had truly sent him.
See that, man? That's not pastor not doing that. Bring it up.
This is the book of Daniel, chapter 7, verse 18.
Bring it up.
But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom.
What the Lord say?
But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom.
Now we're going to ask for our kingdom back.
But for the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom.
The Lord said we're going to take the kingdom.
Right.
You understand? Read.
And possess the kingdom forever.
For how long?
Forever.
And how long?
Forever. Even forever and ever.
Forever.
Yeah.
Ever.
Come.
What y'all think, man? What y'all think, man? Talk to me.
True.
Huh? Read that.
God, so we go to Daniel chapter 2, verse 44.
No.
And in the days of these kings shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed.
This kingdom that God is about to set up is never going to be destroyed.
Right.
There's never been a kingdom on earth that has never been destroyed. Every kingdom has fallen. But for some reason, people think this white man's kingdom going to last forever. This ain't the kingdom that it's talking about.
Right.
You understand? That's talking about our kingdom.
That's right.
What our king, Yahweh Shah, is going to reign, who the world even calls Jesus Christ. That kingdom is never going to be destroyed. That's what I want, bro. I don't want this. This place is hell, man.
Right.
You understand? I want the kingdom that's never going to be destroyed, man. I want to be safe, man. You understand? Read.
God. And the kingdom shall not be left to other people.
Wait a minute. Now we're going to share it.
And the kingdom shall not be left to other people.
Now the kingdom kingdom of heaven is for everybody.
It shall not be left to other people.
The kingdom is not for every. It's not going to be left to other people.
Right.
You understand? All these nations, all these people have benefited on the spoils that they took from us, destroying us. So when we get our kingdom back, it's not going to be left to other people. You understand? Brothers with it?
Come.
Got any more questions?
But it shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdom, and it shall stand forever.
Mm-hmm. Did your question get answered?
Yeah, it been answered.
You got a question? You got no question, bro?
Right, I got a question.
Oh, what's up, man? What's going on, bro? What's up, man?
At Revelation, in Genesis, like when he was telling the prophecy of Judah.
What about Judah in 49, Genesis 49?
Yeah.
Go to Genesis 49. Go to Zechariah 12 and 7.
Genesis 49.
Brother, where you go? Oh, I thought the brother came in the left. What are you asking about?
Like, did it prophesy on Revelation? It said something about Judah.
Oh, it's just talking about just tribalism. It's just talking about the tribes and the order set up. Read Judah.
8.
Yeah.
Genesis chapter 49, verse 8.
Bring it out.
Judah, thou art whom thy brethren shall praise.
Because Judah is the top tribe, right? Give me Hebrews 7 and 14. Go ahead.
Thy hand shall be in the neck of thine enemies. Thy father's children shall bow down before thee. Judah is a lion's whelp. From the prey, my son, thou art gone up. He stooped down, he crouched as a lion, and as a old lion, who shall rise him up? Verse 10, the scepter shall not depart from Judah.
The what?
The scepter shall not depart from Judah.
Read.
Nor a lawgiver from between his feet.
Read.
Until Shiloh comes.
Until his what? Until what?
Until Shiloh comes.
Until Shiloh comes, meaning Christ or Yahweh Shah. Read.
And unto him shall the people gather. Slaki. And unto him shall the gathering of the people be.
And what?
And unto him shall the gathering of the people be.
And this can get a little deep going into. Hold on. Yeah, you can get that. But the Levitical priest, you know about the Levitical priesthood? So it's going to be hard for you to understand. So the priesthood, right, is going to be through Christ now.
Right.
Go to you got it.
It's the book of Hebrews, chapter 7, and verse 14.
Bring it out.
For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood.
Right. So it's just going into Yahweh Shah being the king, the ultimate king and the ultimate high priest. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to get too deep in, you don't even understand, you know what I mean? So that's all it's talking about. It doesn't mean that the tribe of Judah is better than Levi. It has nothing to do with it. That's why everybody talking about they Judah.
Judah!
Nah, you ain't got the kingdom. Now, how you get the kingdom of heaven, brother?
How do I get to the kingdom?
Yeah.
All praise.
What's your nationality, man?
Nationality?
Yeah. What's your race? Who are we?
Trinidad.
You Trinidad? What is that? Sound like some of the white men.
I'm an Israelite.
That's right!
That's right!
Benjamin. Israelite for the tribe of Benjamin. What's your tribe, Ben? Levi? What's your tribe? What's your tribe?
Levi.
Levi? Oh, your mom Benjamin? So you what your father is? Alright? Y'all brothers gotta repent, keep the commandments, y'all gotta continue to learn. Y'all live around here? Y'all brothers gotta come out here with us, man. Y'all gotta get with us when we go. That's a lot to do, man. Y'all can't do it by yourself. Y'all need help. You know what I'm saying? That's what we're here for.
That's right.
If y'all really believe in it like y'all say y'all do, action will come behind that.
That's right.
You understand?
Actions are ways.
That's right. Actions are ways, man. Give me the book of Isaiah chapter 34 and verse 5.
Isaiah chapter 35, verse 4.
Bring it up.
Say unto them that are of a fearful heart, be strong.
Oh, be weak.
Be strong.
Be scared.
Be strong.
The Lord said, be strong, read.
Fear not.
Do what?
Fear not.
The Lord said,
fear not.
Fear not, read.
Behold, your God will come with vengeance.
What the Lord say?
Behold, your God will come with vengeance. Even a God with recompense.
Read.
He will come and save you.
What the Lord say?
He will come and save you.
What God say?
He will come and save you.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 18 and verse 21.
Bring it out.
And a mighty angel took up a stone, like a great millstone, and cast it into the sea, saying, Thus with violence.
Right, did you know God was violent? Read.
Shall that great city Babylon be thrown down?
America's gonna be thrown down with great violence.
Right.
The Lord's not gonna come nicely, take America out of power. The Lord's not gonna come off the chair and did a damn big blow horn and said, all Edomites, step out of your houses, walk this way, get on this chariot, and he's gonna nicely take them to the kingdom, get them off the chair. No, man, it's gonna be nasty and bloody.
Everywhere.
All right? It's gonna be bad, man. It's gonna be very violent. Understand that. With great violence, said America be destroyed because nobody's been more violent than her. The Lord calls them the bloody men who didn't hate blood, they loved blood. You understand? So God said blood is going to pursue after them. Read on.
It shall be found no more at all.
What's going to happen to America?
It shall be found no more at all.
America's going to come back into power.
It shall be found no more at all.
They're going to take us down in the kingdom and rebuild another kingdom.
It shall be found no more at all.
Hey, the Lord said, look, first of all, this is a burning house.
Right.
That's correct.
Right? America's been already prophesied to be destroyed and never exist again.
Right.
Right? If your house is on fire right now, right, what would you do? You gonna get out of there.
Right.
What about your shoes, brother? Yeah. What about your TV? Brother, your cell phone is in there. Brother, you got TVs in there. Brother, your stash pot is in there.
All that.
That's right, brother. You gonna leave it behind. That's right. All right, we got better things to do.
Right.
You understand? So the Lord said America's never gonna be found again, right? And with that, we give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh.
Bashem Yahusha.
Kwam Yasurala.
Kwam Yasurala.
Kwam Yasurala.
Kwam Yasurala. Kwam Yasurala.